All right, and welcome everybody to tonight's broadcast of Lockhart Lions Football right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. We're coming to you live from Davenport High School. As the Lockhart Lions, the 3-0 Lockhart Lions, will be taking on the 3-0 Davenport Wolves. Of course, last year, Lockhart played Davenport. Lockhart came out with a big victory. This year, Davenport is eligible for the playoffs as this is their first senior class that's going to be taking the field. And they are 3-0 on the season.
And they're making a strong case to make the playoffs this year because they've been doing great just like we have. And once again, we have another Highlander game. There can be only one at the end.
Oh, yes.
And we'll see if it's going to be Lockhart or Davenport. Definitely think if you weigh them against the teams that we played so far this year, this is definitely the best team that Lockhart has seen. They might be 4A and we might be 5A, but don't sleep on these Wolves.
Don't sleep on them at all. As the Davenport Wolves have faced against three tough opponents, but in those three opponents, they have a combined record of 1-8, with the only team having a victory is Kerrville Tyvee. And as for the Lockhart Lions, their three opponents have a combined record of 3-6. So this is going to be a tough matchup for both teams, and it's going to figure out where both teams stand in their season here as the Lockhart Lions will be having their final non-district game before we take off back to Lionsfield for a homecoming game against Cedar Creek. But we got the Davenport Wolves tonight, and once again, I want to thank everybody for tuning in. Welcome to the Guadalajara Mexican Restaurant pregame show here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. My name is Emilio Sarzuanez. Going to be bringing you all the live play-by-play action. The man you just heard a few minutes ago is T.D. Tom Dunn, the color commentary man. And off to the right side, holding his hand up in front of the sun to keep his eyes blocked from the sun, is the coach, our football analyst for Friday Night Football, Coach Amado Galvez. How's it going, Mr. Galvez?
Going great, Sarge. Ready for a great ball game. It's going to be a big test for the Lockhart Lions. Davenport's a very good football team. And I have the good fortune of having two young men that I coach that are coaching for the Davenport Wolves tonight. And that's Brandon Davis, who coaches the linebackers, the special teams coordinator. And his younger brother, Stephen Davis, who also coaches the linebackers for the Davenport Wolves. Both good. Both these guys do a great job. And they're going to do a good, tough job against Lockhart. They're going to give us all we can handle. So hopefully we'll be able to pull this game out and go home with another victory.
Oh, yes. And once again, joining us on the broadcast, working the camera, and she wanted me to make sure to let everybody know not to get mad at her, as this is going to be her first time back on the camera since last year. She's been doing a lot of work at home with Shimmer Me Tumblers, and she's joining us here tonight, as tonight it is in the stands with the fans. And we have talked about it several times throughout last year's broadcast and through this year's broadcast, that our first year broadcasting varsity football, we were in the visitor stands broadcasting the games. Of course, that was the 2020 season where COVID hit and everything, and we had a great time interacting with the Lockhart Lion fans when we were out here, and we had a great time interacting with the visiting fans when we were playing at home. And we talked about it, and TD, just so happens we're back in the stands with the fans, and it's going to be another great night. And one thing that we liked about it the most was, I'll go ahead and let you explain it, because you explained it just right. And, it's so spot on.
Well, what I miss the most about being up here in the stands with the fans is something that you don't get in the press box, because believe it or not, folks, those press boxes are just about soundproof. Only sound we have coming in is from our crowd mic. So when we're here in the stands, you can feel the heartbeat of the game. You can feel the thud of the big hits. And I absolutely love being up here. And a great show out by the Lockhart fans. We got the Lockhart band here, Lionettes in tow. I think it's going to be a good night for Lockhart.
Well, you'll be able to definitely hear the crowd tonight, because we're sitting right next to the band, so a lot of times we won't be able to hear us, so we'll try to speak a little bit louder.
That's right. You'll get a heavy dose of the Lockhart band tonight, which we absolutely love. So let's talk a little bit about the competition that we're coming up against. The biggest difference in this team from the other teams we played is they have a passing attack. They're averaging 263 yards a game. Their quarterback's averaging 2.5 touchdowns per game, so they will definitely come out and throw the ball. And that's the one area where, when you look at the numbers, they really have an advantage against Lockhart. You know, often with football, you get the run going so that you can then get the pass going. Well, with Lockhart, the run has gone so well that we haven't really got the pass going, as we're only averaging 60 yards a game passing. So I think tonight, in order for Lockhart to beat these Davenport Wolves, we're going to have to see that ball in the air and see some, one, maybe three of these receivers step up.
Yeah, in the categories we're talking about, in total yards, Davenport does have 461 yards per game, while the Lockhart Lions have 365 per game. But the difference in this is the points per game. Lockhart is averaging 40 points per game, while the Davenport Wolves are averaging 33.7 points per game. And we talked about it before we went on air, TD, is Lockhart has scored an average of 21 points in the first quarter and 21 points in the third quarter. But in the second and fourth quarter, they're only averaging 7 points a quarter. So
that's right. So it seems like if we just round it out a little bit, add a touchdown here or there, I mean, we could easily score, you know, 50 points or more tonight. And the other big disparity in the game is the defenses. Lockhart defense allowing about half as many points on the year as Davenport has allowed. And, you know, defense for Lockhart has been a lot of our success, giving the offense short fields to work with, creating turnovers. I think tonight one of the keys to the game for Lockhart on the defensive side of the ball is going to be how well that secondary plays. How well does Trey Brown play back there in the safety position? How well does Deontay Jackson and our cornerbacks? I think it's going to be a real test for them tonight, but I also think with this passing attack, there's going to be a whole lot more opportunities to get those mitts on the ball and try to get it running back the other way for six.
Yes, and definitely the secondary is going to be tested big time today, and it's going to be exciting to see how they're going to be able to stand up to test. Of course, we got the big man up front, who's the smallest lineman on the defensive side, and Derek Rivas, who was lights out last week. And, of course, we overlooked one Josh Ramos, where this young man was all over the place. And let's go and take a quick time and turn on the crowd mic as we're going to have our alma mater playing for the Lockhart Lions.
Play their alma mater as well.
And now Wolves fans.
And we'll keep the crowd mic on and see if we pick that up from across the field for you.
How's George?
There you have it, folks. That's the Davenport Wolves alma mater. I tell you what, we are here and we are sitting facing into the west watching that setting sun. Looks like we got at least 30 minutes before it ducks down behind those home bleachers. So we'll be staring into the sun for probably a good half of the first quarter. And we're here. We're getting ready to see the teams come out onto the field.
All right, I do want to apologize for the shaking of the camera. We're trying to get it level and get it set up.
So much excitement going on. The camera keeps shaking.
Yeah, the camera lady, she's nervous being back on the camera once again. So We'll go ahead and let her slide on that one for a little while.
Going back to what you were saying, TD, if they, the quarterback for Davenport's anything like the JV quarterback for last night for Davenport, he's pretty good. Pretty good player.
Mason Falcone, I sent him a couple of clips of his touchdowns on Twitter, and I tell you what, this young man, he was probably about 5'6".
He's 6'2" now.
Yeah, he's 6'2" now.
So
but
he's grown.
I tell
sure.
you what, when he ran, it was hard to bring him down.
Yeah, he's definitely a big boy. And, you know, kind of going back to what we were talking about earlier, the differences in the team, you know, Davenport has allowed 37 points a game, while Lockhart's defense has been stingy, one of the most stingy defenses in Central Texas, as we're in the top 10 on fewest points allowed with only 16 per game. So Davenport giving up twice as many points as Lockhart. We'll need it tonight if we want to get out of here with a victory.
TD, you would have loved seeing the Davenport JV defensive line. They did an excellent job playing technique, well coached. I expect to see the same thing tonight from the varsity D line for the Davenport Wolves.
And it's going to be a big test because we got a great front line, as last week they were our Kreitz Market Offensive Players of the Game, which is the entire front line, as they created a whole bunch of holes up front. And out of the 10 possessions Lockhart had, they scored on 8 of them, six running and 2 passing TDs.
Well, and it was a great game last week all the way around. Everyone leaving the stands with smiles on their faces. I tell you what, folks.
Except for Layman.
But it's been a long time since we found ourselves in this position. And something we're trying to do tonight is get to 4-0. And if we do indeed get to 4-0, it will be the first time Lockhart has done that since 2007. So it's definitely been a while since we've been in the situation that we're in now. Hopefully we can go out there and eclipse that record.
And that'll be and that's going to be a great start to this season, as once again this is the last non-district game. So whatever happens after today, really means nothing when it comes to the playoffs, because like I always talk about, in all the high school sports, there's three seasons. You got your non-district, you got your district, and then whatever you do in district is going to determine if you make it to that third season, which
exactly,
is the playoff.
Exactly, so, Sergeant. That's why you see a lot of schools that plays real, real tough non-district games to not only to toughen up the team, but it doesn't matter. You want to win every game, but at the same time, it doesn't. Once this is dark, all that's in the trash can.
Well,
yes.
And talking about those really tough games, that comes down to strength of schedule. And that's time, when you see the state rankings. You'll see teams that have two losses that are 1-2 that are still ranked in the top, 15.
Yes.
And the reason they're able to do that is their strength of schedule. Just like Coach says, we got Liberty Hill in our district. Well, they went out right away and scheduled a game against Hutto, who is an absolute powerhouse. And they went up there and they played them to a close game. They lost to Hutto. They did drop a little bit, but they are still ranked number 10 in the state of Texas.
Yes. As we get set, the Lockhart Lions will be coming out of their tunnel. So it doesn't seem like it's going to be too bad. We're right here with the band. I got the microphone on the far side away from them. Yes, it is. And here come the Lions. They're getting pumped up as you see Ashton Dickens and Trey Brown leading the Lockhart Lions out onto the field. And Blake Herzog coming up. Look at the Lion and the Lockhart Lady Lion cheerleaders coming out. And this is the first time Lockhart's playing here at Davenport Field.
Yep, and the Lions tonight will be in those beautiful white jerseys with the black pants, maroon stripe down the side with Lions on it, and those signature matte black helmets that just look so beautiful with that logo on it.
Yeah, and here come the Davenport Wolves, 3-0 on the season. As we mentioned earlier, this is their first year varsity eligible. And eligible to make it, playoff eligible. And, of course, we got some homegrown Lockhart fellas out there. Coach, would you like to let them know?
Yes, sir. We got Brandon Davis, who's the special teams coordinator. And we have Steven Davis, who's the linebacker coach for the Davenport Wolves. Both ex-Lockhart Lions. And I guarantee you, they're going to do a great job tonight. They're ready. They're up for this game.
Oh, yeah, especially after last year, Lockhart came away with a huge victory. I want to believe Lockhart put 60 on the board against Davenport. But this is a different team from last year.
Yes,
this team is a lot more. They got more experience, And this is their first year with varsity players on the field.
Well, and I tell you, with them building towards this year and it being the first year of having varsity on the field, one thing that you know that they've done is been through adversity.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, these are your future Wolves right here.
For example, last year, you know, they come into Lockhart, we play them, well, and they don't have a kid on their team that's over 16 years old last year. So it's, you know.
It's a big difference. Yeah,
yes,
big difference.
And you know they're going to have been shaped by that. Facing that adversity in their few years, these seniors are going to be ready to come out here and give Lockhart a tough game. I love the color scheme that we'll have in this game. We've got the maroon on our pants on the bottom, white tops. They've got the maroon tops with the white bottoms. It almost looks like Lockhart versus Lockhart out there.
Make sure you're on the right side.
And the captain's about to come out onto the field for the coin toss for Lockhart. We've got number 5, Sean McKinney. We've got number 44, that's Trent Holcomb. Number 11, which is our quarterback, Ashton Dickens. And number 31, Deontay Jackson.
Number 12, Jaden Soberall. Number 14,
coming across on the far side, captains for Davenport is going to be Zahir Livingston, number 5. They're going to have number 12, Jaden Soberall out there. They're going to have number 25. That's going to be Judge Erickson. And big number 55 for Davenport is Carter Traynor.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time,
as we see players shaking hands, getting to know each other. And Lockhart with a pretty good crowd here in San Antonio.
Late arriving crowd, but they're just starting to come in, TD.
They're pouring in now.
This summer's Wolves football camp, our punt, pass, and kick winners. We'll start with the second grader from Garden Ridge Elementary School, Hayes Deedle.
Head coach is recognized as the winners of the punt PPK contest.
Their Davenport pass, punt, and kick contest that they held over the summer.
And
looks like we're just about ready for the coin toss. Referee's gone through explaining to everyone and showing everybody the coin.
And the winner from the sixth grade at Spring Branch Middle School.
And last week we saw Lockhart defer to the second half. We'll see what they decide to do this week. If they do indeed win the toss. Davenport has won the toss, and they have elected to receive. So we will see Lockhart Lions defense coming out first. Davenport has elected to defend the north end of the stadium, which we've got a slight wind coming out of the southeast, headed into the northwest.
Yeah.
Not enough, I don't think, to affect any passing out here today.
And I do want to make an observation. You could see a glare right in the middle of the screen, but that's because we are facing the sun is facing right at us, so that's coming off the glare off of the camera, but that'll soon go away. Hopefully midway through the first quarter or midway through the second quarter, it'll be gone, but you're still going to be able to get a great look at some football
just
as we get ready for the national anthem.
Just bear with us.
Yes.
As we see the Davenport ROTC presenting the colors, we'll get ready to give you guys the national anthem.
And carrying the colors of the United States of America, Cadet Braden Davis. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, Sadie Daly will sing our national anthem.
Proudly we hailed
ladies and gentlemen, it is high school football time in Central Texas. What a beautiful rendition of the national anthem by that young lady.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was a student here at Davenport, Sadie Daly.
You got to give it up to Sadie Daly.
Our nation's colors, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you remain standing until the flags leave the field of play. And thank you to our junior ROTC for the presentation of the colors.
So, Sarge, we'll get to see that Lockhart defense out on the field first, who's been so stingy so far this year, only allowing 16 points a game. One of the best in Central Texas.
And I do want to give a shout-out to our main sponsor, Kent Riddle of Kent Riddle Properties. I want to thank him for all he's done for supporting Lockhart Lions Sports and being a big supporter of the Lions Pride Sports broadcast. And not only that, Kent Riddle also does a QA for us back at his home studio to make sure that we sound good and look good for all you Lockhart Lion fans out there. Make sure y'all get the best picture and the best sound out of every broadcast right here on the Lions Pride Sports broadcast.
Thank you, Mr. Riddle. Thank you. Thank you. Awesome job. Keep up the good
and
work,
also
sir.
We also want to give a shout-out to the Lounge Sports Bar, the official watch party of Lockhart Lion football right here on the Lions Pride Sports broadcast. Want to give them a big shout-out and raise one up as your Lockhart Lions look to go 4-0. All right. But they got a tough task ahead of them. And the way is number is 3-0, Davenport Wolves. And back deep to return the kick for the Davenport Wolves is going to be number 0, Darian Brown. And number 1, Emmett Greeman. Of course, kicking the ball off for the Lockhart Lions is going to be Omar Ocampo.
And real quick, before the kickoff, I want to talk about how Lockhart is climbing that ladder. What do I mean by that, folks? Lockhart has moved up 135 spots in the overall ranking in the state of Texas. And they have moved up to 38 in 5A Division II. They started out well over 50, but have clawed their way up. Jumps each week. Got to think if we get a big win here tonight, we'll see another bump.
As we get set for the start of this game, 12 minutes on the clock, and this game is underway. It's going to be a high pooch kick, and that'll be called by number 13, Dante Singletary. He tries to bring it up. He'll cross a 20, and he's going to be swallowed up by number 20 for the Lockhart Lions and number 7.
Number 3, Ramos, is the first one down there that slowed him down.
That's right. Ramos slowed him down, and the rest of them came in and cleaned him up.
That's going to be Jazz Burton and number 20, Jose Rivera Fabian, in on the stop. And at quarterback for the Davenport Wolves.
And looks like
a penalty.
Yeah,
no.
They just need to spot
just,
the ball.
Yeah, spot it.
So we'll see how long it takes before Lockhart takes Davenport takes a shot down the field, as we know they will be taking some shots tonight.
And that quarterback for the Davenport Wolves is going to be Tristan Hamlin, number 10.
It didn't take Lehman very long to take a shot downfield.
It didn't. So here we go, first play of the game. Hamilton rolls around to his left side, throws it out there, got the receiver wide open. Breaks through an arm tackler before he's finally going to be brought down, but right there on the spot to start it off, that was number 25 for the Lions.
Looked like a buster, TD. Looked like the receiver came open, and there was nobody there.
Yep, that's a quick 8-yard pickup. We'll call it 7. It's going to be 2nd and 3 for the Wolves. Ball is going to be on the 68-yard line.
We've got 3 receivers up top. Man in motion coming across. They'll fake the jet sweep, hand the ball up off the middle. Huge hole for the running back. It's going to be a foot race, crosses midfield. Past the 30, the 25, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Wolves. And that's number 11, Jaden Soberall.
I tell you what, Lockhart developing a bad habit of letting these teams score early on.
Yeah, we can't have that. We can't have TD. I'm sure you saw the same thing I did. The tight end was blocking our linebacker in the back, and referee, of course, didn't see it, unfortunately.
Well, and I tell you what, it's one thing to give up a quick touchdown against a team like Lehman. It's a whole other thing to do it here in the Davenport Wolves' house.
So the Davenport Wolves are going to be going for the extra point try. Josh Gill, the snap is back, the hold is down, the kick is up, and it is good, and a penalty flag comes out.
The snap was low, but the quarterback, the holder, did an excellent job of getting hold of the football and putting it down for the kicker.
He sure did.
They might get Lockhart offsides, and that's the case.
Yes, yes.
So it'll be offsides on the Lions. That'll be declined. The extra point is good. And just like that, the Davenport Wolves have a 7-0 lead.
Yep. Definitely not what Lockhart Lions fans want to see. as Davenport strikes quickly and puts seven up on the board. Now it'll be up to this offense to answer quickly. Now, if you weren't here for the pregame show, we talked a little bit about the statistics. Lockhart has been rushing the ball over 300 yards per game. The area where we've been lacking is passing, but a lot of time when you're scoring and getting points on the board by rushing the ball like we are, you never really get to the pass. But I think if Lockhart's going to be successful tonight, we're going to need to see young Ashton Dickens air this ball out a little bit against Davenport.
TD, as you noticed, the defense coordinator got all the defense on the bench, and he's giving them pretty good tongue lashing there. Hopefully they'll wake up.
Man, rightfully so. I mean, they woke up last week after Lehman scored on the first play. This time it took Davenport two plays to get into the end zone. As Josh Gill will be kicking the ball off deep on the far side will be Sean McKinney. And here on the near side is going to be Deontay Jackson. Usually it's Quavon Reese back there, but they got Sean McKinney back there.
Let's see if the Davenport decides to kick deep to us. No, sir.
And that's going to be a high pooch kick.
Out of bounds, out of bounds.
Bounce out of bounds right around the 32-yard line. That'll be a legal procedure.
Lockhart, lucky it did bounce out of bounds because that play was designed for Davenport to be able to recover that kick. And number 17 was about a half second late from being able to get his hands on that football.
And, gentlemen, I'm noticing Quavon Reese does not have his helmet in his hand. I'm pretty sure that's probably a self-imposed suspension that the coaches applied after last week's game where, you know, teams got kind of a little chippy towards the end of the game. And Quavon Reese was in there and of course, they weren't ejected from the game, but I'm pretty sure Coach Mavis is making a statement that we can't be having that no matter what the score is or who we're playing against.
Good point, Sarge. Great report.
We see the Lockhart offense come out onto the field. They're going to start out with a two-back set, having both McKinney and Jackson in the backfield with Dickens.
I got two receivers to the near side, one up top. So here we go, first snap of the game for the Lockhart Lions. Dickens gets it, hands it off to Deontay Jackson, who comes around the near side. Nice open field tackle by number five, Zaire Livingston.
I just saw there, Sarge, the defensive line for the Davenport did a little shift right before the snap, and that's to throw the blocking off of the Lockhart Lions.
And that's going to go for no gain. And that's going to bring up second down and 10. McKinney had a big block on that one, but they still were able to corral Jackson so he can cross the line of scrimmage.
This time Jackson will shift down to the near side. He'll be the wide receiver as they got two receivers to the bottom, one up top.
He'll be covered by number zero, who is one of the best players on their team.
And it looks like they're going to get the Lockhart Lions for a false start.
I mentioned number zero. That's Darian Brown. You'll see him on both sides of the ball. He has definitely been a star for this Davenport team so far this year.
So 5-yard mark off would make it second down and 15. Once again, I want to give a big shout out to my wife who's back with us, working the camera. Yes, sir. Kent Riddle mentions the sun is almost gone. Yeah. So Lockhart Lions not going into the huddle.
I'm sure it's the same play they called before.
Appreciate my QC letting me know my mic is lower than the band.
An inside handoff, or Dickens is going to keep it. He'll go around the left side. Gets around the edge, and he'll pick up a good chunk of yardage all the way down to the 41-yard line, line territory.
So he'll get the 5 yards back from the penalty, and then he'll also get back another few yards. Yeah, so that'll bring up 37.
Picks up 8 yards on the carry. So third down and 7 coming up. Got three receivers to the bottom, one up top.
Both the secondary players down here on the bottom playing outside, which often leaves the inside slant open.
And a nice pass to Deontay Jackson, who makes the catch. Ooh. And another great open field tackle by Darian Brown. But the Lockhart Lions pick up the first down in Wolf territory.
Like TD said, that corner playing for the Davenport Wolves, number zero, was excellent player, excellent tackle there.
Playing a little bit deep or far off the receiver, especially a man like Deontay Jackson. You cannot do that, and Deontay Dickens puts it right in there. Jet sweep to Jackson. He cuts it upfield. And it looks like he might have picked up 1 yard, so that'll bring up second down and 9.
And so far the Lions unable to get the running game going.
They're going to give him 2 yards, so it'll be second down and 8. As we have 9:42 left to go here in the A1 Bell Bonds first quarter here on the Lions Pride Sports broadcast. Davenport Wolves score on the second play of the game. Extra point is good, and that's where we stand at right now. Davenport 7, Lockhart 0. But the Lockhart Lions have their first possession of the game, and they're moving the ball down the field, find themselves in Wolf territory. Dickens gets the snap, quarterback keeper all the way, got some room. Nice blocking up front by the front lineman. And Dickens gets all the way down to the 35-yard line.
And that's just quarterback power. Just getting behind your backs and picking up what you can. Going to be a third and very manageable for the Lions.
So third down and 2 for the Lions. They'll hand the ball off to McKinney. He'll put his shoulders down and lean forward, and he'll pick up the first down.
And on the second effort, we always talk about that with McKinney. It's yards after contact. Seems like about 90% of his yards do come after contact. Yeah.
Zaire Livingston making a hit in the backfield, but Sean McKinney proving to be the stronger runner and able to push forward, like as TD said, on the second effort.
See that shift by the nose guard there, TD? It doesn't matter because our center did an excellent blocking job on him.
Well, this is definitely a bigger defensive line than we faced last week from Lehman.
Dickens gets the snap, rolls around to his left side.
Great catch.
Got Gage Deutsch out there, the sophomore.
And Sarge, we talked about him last week. Really blew up in the scrimmages for the Lions, had several big catches, threw a couple big balls for in the scrimmage as well, and have been waiting for Gage to pop off, and who knows, tonight could be his night.
Yes, it's been so far receiver by committee, as each week a receiver has stepped up and played the role for the number one spot.
Blake Herzog does lead the receiving corps with 2 touchdown catches. Both came in the game against Conley.
Second down and 3 coming up. Low snap. Gets past Dickens, and he'll have to fall on it.
He did the best thing he could there.
That's right. He showed his maturity once again. Didn't try to do anything crazy. Just got down on the ball, kept it safe, and kept possession for his team. Going to bring up 3rd and 10 for Lockhart. Ball's going to be on the 33-yard line.
Actually, it's going to be 3rd down and 11.
Oh, sorry.
The referee was there. The down marker wasn't. But here it is, 3rd down and 11 coming up. Dickens is getting the play call from the sideline from Coach Gilbert, the offensive coordinator for the Lockhart Lions. Head coach Todd Mavis in his 4th year as a head coach and athletic director of Lockhart High School. And that one's going to be a handoff to Sean McKinney. He'll come around the near and got room to run. First down around the edge, and he's going to be pushed out of bounds right around the 13-yard line. And a big play call on 3rd down and 11.
All speed there for the Lions on that one, on the speed sweep. Sean McKinney never had to think about a juke. He just shifted it into third gear and put the pedal to the metal.
And once again, great blocking up front around the outside. And Sean McKinney just used his speed to get out there. 1st down and 10 at the 13. Snap and pitch it out to Sean McKinney. Let him do his thing, go around the edge. And he's going to be ran out of bounds.
Ooh,
there's going to be a penalty flag coming in late as he was ran out at the 6-yard line.
And it looked like that was supposed to be a stretch play handoff that kind of turned into a touch on a little bit of a bobbled snap. But Dickens able to get a hold of the ball and get it to McKinney. And he did push it forward for a positive gain, but the penalty is going to go against Lockhart. We'll see what that penalty is.
So they're going to mark 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
Well, that'll be holding on the Lions.
It'll still be 1st down for Lockhart.
10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay 1st down.
Well, that's going to be 1st and 20.
That'll be 1st and 14.
1st and 14.
Yeah, they marked it from the spot of the foul.
Lockhart's still in the red zone here. Ball's going to be on the 17-yard line.
You can hear see the shake of the camera as we are in the stands with the fans tonight. And that's going to be a quarterback keeper right up the middle. And Dickens using his power and his big frame.
Good tough run. Good tough run by our quarterback.
And a beautiful play fake on that one as all eyes were following Deontay Jackson coming around the edge while Dickens kept the ball up the middle for a gain of 5 yards.
And that'll bring up second down and 9.
They're going to have to put a spy on our quarterback, TD, because he's a dangerous runner.
Well, my favorite thing about a spy is a lot of time that will open up a flat route for
yes,
you
sir.
Where you're able to get him on the perimeter, get the ball in just behind that spy.
Dickens gets the snap, fakes the handoff to McKinney, keeps it himself, goes around the left, right side. Stiffs arm a defender, still on his feet, inside the 5, down to the 1 yard line, where it'll be first down and goal to goal from the 1.
And what an extra effort by Dickens to keep pumping his feet, extend the ball out past the sticks, and pick up a first down for his team. Young man's playing with heart tonight.
And Dickinson has C.J. Tanner on his heels as well as Darian Brown. Right around the 6 yard line, but Dickens able to advance 5 more yards up the field down to the 1. We're going to be first down and goal to go from the 1 yard line with 5:54 left to go. Here in the A1 Bell Bonds, hand off to McKinney over the left side, and that's going to be a Lockhart Lions touchdown.
And we got ourselves a ball game here at Davenport.
And if you're watching the game at the Lounge Sports Bar, hold one up because that's a Lockhart Lions touchdown.
And we'll see Mr. Omar Ocampo come in to get the extra point for the Lions.
And Trent Holcomb, the long snapper. Gage Deutsch, the holder, snap is back, hold it down, the kick is up, and right through the uprights, it is good. And this game is all tied up with 5:49 left to go in the A1 Bell Bonds first quarter. We're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back with more Lockhart Lions football right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
Hi, I'm Richard Mendez with A1 Bell Bonds. If you find yourself in a jam, we're your plan. We'll put your feet back on the street. A1 Bell Bonds. Go Lions.
The Lounge Sports Bar, located at 211 East Market Street, just off of downtown Lockhart. The right place to have a great time with friends and enjoy the game on our big screen TVs. We have a large bar lounge, allowing for many people to crowd around and cheer on your favorite team. The Lounge Sports Bar, open 7 days a week, starting at 11 a.m. The best place in Lockhart to enjoy cold beverages and watch live sports. So make the Lounge Sports Bar your favorite destination for sports and drinks.
And we are back as Sean McKinney puts the ball in the end zone for a 1 yard plunge around the left side. Omar Ocampo with the extra point, and it is all tied up at 7 apiece with 5:49 left to go here in the A1 Bell Bonds first quarter. And the Lockhart Lions Warren Band is rocking.
Fielded right at the 7 yard line.
And that's going to be brought up field by number 0, Brown, and he's going to bring it all the way up across the 35 yard line.
And we told you about him. That is Darian Brown. Keep your eyes on number 0, whether he's on defense or offense. He has been making big plays for this Davenport team all year so far.
And that ball is going to be placed at the 36 yard line where the Davenport Wolves will have the ball first down and 10 for their second possession of the night.
Looks like we're about 5 minutes away from getting that sun out of our eyes and your eyes, folks. Hang in there with us.
And once again, at the quarterback position is Tristan Hamilton. We got 3 receivers to the near side, 1 up top. And he'll hand the ball off to number 14 going around the far edge. And he's going to be chased out of bounds.
Number 3.
By Josh Ramos. And that's Shaston Golden with the carry.
And I want to point out for Lockhart on the near side, you've got number 20, Jose Fabian Rivera, and he is in there for Quavon Reese.
Getting his first start here on varsity. That is second down and 7 for the Wolves. Quarterback drops back to throw, gets it out there to his receiver, number 1, Emmett Greiman. And he'll get it all the way to the 43-yard line.
Number two in the tackle for the Lions.
And this is what you'll see for Davenport, folks. A lot of quick passes, a lot of passes out on the perimeter, getting the ball out of their quarterback's hands quickly.
Yeah, Barkey on the stop. Quick pass out to the far side. Hamilton gets it out there to number 19. Or Hamilton gets it out there to Kyler Payne.
And that's a statistic that on all levels is a huge deal on how fast the quarterback gets his hands out, get the ball out of his hands. Really hard to sack a guy who gets the ball out of his hands in under a second and a half.
First down and 10, you're going to throw the ball deep down the near side, and that's going to be incomplete as that pass was intended for, once again, Kyler Payne.
Number 19 had a hard time getting away from our cornerback, number 20.
And Payne's protesting, looking for a flag, but he doesn't get one.
And Fabian did an outstanding job covering Payne out here. As this time the Bulls bring three receivers to the near side, one up top. Hamlin in the backfield. They'll fake the jet sweep, hand it off to number 14. And once again, going right up the middle. Nobody behind him. And that'll be the second touchdown for Shostin Golden.
And that is a breakdown in the scheme as there was nobody in the middle of the field for the Lions, nobody on the second or third level there to slow him down, and he's able to run into the end zone for an easy 7 points.
Good strategy there as far as for the Davenport offensive coaches.
7 points pending the extra point. That's right. You know, why do you change something? If it worked for you the first time, keep coming back to it.
Josh Gill coming in there, kick the extra point, snap his back, hold his down, the kick is up, and it is good. And the Davenport Wolves strike back on a long touchdown run by number 14, Shostin Golden, and now lead the Lions with 5:09 left to go here in the A1 Bell Bonds first quarter by a score of 14-7. As far as the score tonight, Davenport has had the two home runs.
Sarge, what they're doing, if they give you this formation, Lockhart lines up to this formation, and there's nobody in the middle of the field. So every time they get in that formation, the middle is wide open.
Yes. And whereas most teams, you'll see them run the ball to open up the pass, looks like Davenport Wolves are throwing the ball to open up that middle run as they take that man in motion across the formation. They clear out the middle and create an imbalance and attack it.
And right now, the Davenport Wolves offense is doing a great job in attacking the Lockhart Lions defense, who's been so good the last 3 weeks. And Davenport Wolves has already surpassed the point total per game that Lockhart has been giving up.
And you see the defensive coordinator, as soon as he came to the sidelines, he grabbed that grease board, and he's making adjustments. I guarantee you, he's going to make some adjustments.
So Gill will be coming in to kick the ball away. And once again, back deep for the Lions, going to be Sean McKinney on the far side with Deontay Jackson on the near side. And as we saw before, it was a high boot kick out of bounds. And it doesn't look like it looks like Davenport has looked at film on for the special teams for Lockhart. And they definitely do not want anybody to get a hold of one and bring it back.
The special teams coordinator is Brandon Davis, and he's a sharp cookie. He's going to make his adjustments.
Go to Herzog right around the 30.
And he'll catch it at the 28. He'll bring it upfield and he'll be hit. But with forward progress, this should get him back down right around the 31, 32-yard line where the Lions will take over first down and 10.
Folks, it looks like we may have a shootout of Bruin. It's going to be tit for tat. Lockhart's going to have to answer to keep themselves in this ballgame.
Yes, sir. Defense is going to have to step up.
And, wow, they're going to put the ball back at the 29. Looks like forward progress was stopped at the 32.
And you can see that Lockhart defense down on the sideline. Nobody's hanging their head. Everybody's intently listening. Players talking to other players. Coaches talking to players, trying to get it figured out and stop the bleeding.
As Coach Mavis is down there talking to him. Of course, Coach Mavis is a defensive guy.
He sure is.
So Lockhart has two fullbacks in the backfield, two running backs, and fakes the handoff. Dickens goes right over the left side. He'll cross the line of scrimmage all the way down to the 31-yard line, and that'll bring up second down and 8 for the Lions.
Well, we've seen Dickens with some good decisions on the zone read already tonight, as quite a few times on that zone read, they have definitely accounted for the running back, McKinney or Jackson, depending on which one of them it is. They've accounted for him. And that's enabled Dickens to hold on to that ball and pick up positive yardage.
Second down and 8. We are right at 4.5 minutes left to go here in the A1 Bell Bonds first quarter.
Only 6 men in the box.
Yeah, look, dropping it back to throw. Got Herzog wide open at the 39-yard line.
That's a first down.
He turns it up, takes it upfield all the way to the 44-yard line.
Great job by Herzog finding the soft spot in that zone defense. Sitting down where Dickens is able to find it and picking up a first down for the Lions.
Yeah, it's a great job by Herzog to catch it, see that ball all the way into his hands before making a move, and as soon as he had it in his hands, made a quick move, took it straight upfield, and picked up a big first down for the Lockhart Lions.
And that's exactly what we're going to have to see tonight for the Lions to compete in this game. We're going to have to see the ball move down the field, not just on the ground, but through the air as well.
Dickens, quarterback keeper, coming around the near side. And he'll pick up a handful of yards. Picks up about 6 yards, and that'll bring up second down. That picks up 5 yards. That'll be second down and 5 for the Lions.
And that's been something the Lions have been great at so far this year, is keeping themselves in manageable situations. The times that they haven't done that has been pulling out the old proverbial pistol and shooting themselves in the foot
right.
with penalties, as we have seen. Quite a few penalties in the first 3 games for the Lions.
Yeah, especially against Pflugerville Collingwood. Lockhart amassed 16 penalties in that game alone.
For, I want to say, 90 yards is what we lost in that game.
And inside handoff to Sean McKinney. Another tough run by the young Lion.
Good tough run.
And he was about a step from getting to daylight there.
Third and short.
That'll bring up third down and 2.
Yes. See, Lockhart's going to bring in the tight end, so they're going to go with 11 personnel. As Holcomb comes into the game, be number 44 on your near side.
Not only is Holcomb a great blocker, tackler on defense, he's a great addition on the offensive side of things as a great blocker on the edge.
So third down and 3.
Inside handoff to McKinney, and he gets room up the middle. Picks up another Lockhart line first down to the 41-yard line. You could see McKinney, once he got hold of that football, he held onto it both hands.
Lockhart going quick, catching Davenport subbing out. And we didn't
And they're going to call a timeout.
Yeah, they had to call
a
timeout.
Yeah, they had to call a timeout.
They were going to get stuck with 12 men on the field as Lockhart did not sub, went with a hurry-up. So Davenport has to burn one of their timeouts early here in the second quarter.
And we're going to keep it right here, and we'll take you around the district of other district games. Here in District 13, 5A, Division 2 for the Lockhart Lions in our division. Veterans Memorial is playing at Canyon Lake. San Antonio Piper Comal Piper is at Hallettsville. Veterans Memorial is 2-1, Canyon Lake 1-2, Piper 0-3, Hallettsville 3-0. 0-3 Cedar Creek is at Elgin, 2-1 Elgin. 0-3 Bastrop Bears is at Pflugerville. Taking on the Panthers, both those teams are 0-3. The 2-1 Liberty Hill Panthers is at Leander Rouse.
That's a big game.
Yeah, it's at 1-2 for the Rouse Raiders.
We talked about that earlier, scheduling tough opponents for preseason.
And another big game, Kerrville Tyvee, who sits at 1-2, taking on former Lockhart Lion football head coach, Coach Herman at Marble Falls, who is 2-1 on the season.
They're going to see a lot of Slanty.
Yeah, as we get back into action, it is first down and 10. Ball is at the 41-yard line. McKinney in motion. Mishandle off the snap is Dickens. He'll have to eat it and take it up the field.
Snap was low, threw the timing off. He got what he could out of it.
Yeah. Well, good job to get what he could out of it, too, because he was deep in the backfield. McKinney was already past him. I think that was supposed to be a jet sweep to McKinney, or a read anyway.
With a slow snap, we know that what happens there, right, TD?
That's right.
Second and 11 for the Lions. Back to pass.
Dickens is going to tuck it in, and he'll run forward. And he'll get it all the way down to the 37-yard line. That'll bring up third down and 6.
Good job of pass coverage by the Davenport Wolves.
That's right. As you can see, Dickens working through his progressions. He went 1, 2, and then 3 before he finally decided to pull the ball down and got some positive yardage for the Lions. And last time the Lions had third down on this end of the field, they were able to rip off a big run as Dickens pushed it down the field and got stopped at the 1.
So third down and 6 coming up for the Lions with 1 minute, 18 seconds left to go here in the A1 Bell Bond first quarter. Dickens drops back, looking to pass, got Wolves right in front of him, throws it out there, has Zakiya Gathings unable to hang on to it as he was well covered on the play by number 17, Singletary, and that's going to bring up fourth down and six.
And they're right in that gray area of the field where you're a little bit outside of Ocampo's
range,
but you're also just a little too close to punt it. The Lions will go for it here on fourth and six.
Oh, they were a snap away from making it fourth down and one.
Middle of the field, wide open.
And it's going to be a keeper going around the left side. A penalty flag comes in.
And that is going to be offsides on the defense.
If it is, that's going to be huge. As Dickens was able to pick up one.
So I wonder, the player that jumped off and got back looked like he might have maybe stayed in the neutral zone, didn't get all the way back across.
Looks that way, TD.
Coach Mavis looking for a call.
And they're going to call offsides on Lockhart. Or
it's interesting because they threw the flag but did not whistle the play dead.
Well, on offsides, they'll let it play out just in case there's a fumble on the play. On false start, of course, they'll blow the play dead, but Lockhart turns the ball over on downs. And the Davenport Wolves will have the ball first down and 10 at their own 35-yard line as Hamlin brings his Wolves out onto the field.
So Lockhart fails to answer Davenport, and they're up 14-7, and now they've got the ball again.
Hamlin drops back to left-hander, throws the ball down the side, and that's almost going to be picked off by Fabian.
And Zakiya Gathens with a huge hit on Tanner, driving him into the turf and making a bad throw on that. Rivera Fabian was really close to getting an interception on that play. And it looks like we've got an injury on the field, so we'll go ahead and pan away from that.
We'll take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back with more Lockhart Lion football right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
Ken Riddle Properties is the main sponsor of the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast for the 2022 to 2023 season and has been a big supporter of Lockhart Lion Sports for over 40 years. Lockhart Lion fans all over the world have been able to follow the games on the Kent Riddle Properties scoreboard, as well as being the main sponsor of the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. Ken is also the QA guy for every broadcast. Kent Riddle has been in the real estate business for over 35 years. If you are looking to buy, sell, or lease a property in the area, you can contact Kent Riddle at 512-359-0036.
All right, and that's going to bring up second down and 10 for the Wolves. Young man was able to get up and walk off the field underneath his own power. Now, running back's going to come out the backfield. Hamlin will hand the ball off to the first man up. And that'll be about a 5-yard gain. That'll bring up third down and five as Emmett Griman on the carry.
And that's Josh Ramos on the stop. And that's the same play we've seen them score on twice. So definitely a better result than the last two times we saw it.
So third down and five coming up for the Wolves.
Man coverage across the board.
Hamlin's going to roll out, and that pass is going to be caught by number 13, Dante Singletary, as he runs out of bounds. And that's going to be first down and 10 in Lion territory. And great move by Singletary.
Here we go, no huddle.
And we've got 23 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. It'll be interesting to see as we get into the second if we see Quavon Reese come into the game.
Hamlin dropping back, got pressure around him, and the pocket closes in on him as Trent Holcomb and Travion Hopkins comes in.
And I tell you what, Lockhart needed a big play, and it looks like that will be the last play of the first quarter. Score is Davenport Wolves 14, Lockhart 7.
And we're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back with the Adam & Sons AC and Heating second quarter right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
Adam & Sons AC and Heating is a locally owned business. President, CEO, and U.S. Navy veteran Adam Renteria has been certified in HVAC since 2010. Adam is also certified as a home performance specialist through BPI. Adam & Sons offers professional work, excellent quality service, with affordable prices. Whether it's commercial or residential, Adam & Sons is the one to call. Contact Adam & Sons AC and Heating at 512-844-2695 or email adamrenteria64air@yahoo.com. Mention you heard this ad on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast and get 10% off your service call.
And we are back for the start of the second quarter, the Adam and Sons AC and Heating second quarter. As we flip-flop fields, now the Davenport Wolves will be going left to right as your Lockhart Lions will be going right to left right here on the Lions Pride Sports broadcast.
And Lockhart with a big sack, putting Davenport going to be pretty close to second and 10 as they get the chains reset in the other direction.
Yeah, second down is 17, TD.
Close enough.
Yeah, you just put your glasses on too. Man.
They fogged up.
TD, going back what you were saying, if old coach told me if you can't cover them, bring them.
Oh, yeah.
And they sure did on that last play as they brought the house, and it was man covered across the board.
So here we go. Second down is 17. Hampling gets the snap, throws it out there to the receiver out there in the flat. And great job out there by Trey Bound, slowing up the receiver, number four. David Miller and Deontay Jackson coming in to make the stop.
Third down. Brown coming straight upfield to attack that wide receiver bubble screen and disrupting it, allowing Jackson to make a tackle.
You got two on top. No, there we go. We got it covered down.
Hamlin rolls around to his left side, throws it out there.
Out of bounds.
Far out of bounds.
Good pressure for the backside there, Sarge.
So they've had continual pressure in this drive, and it looks like the pressure may be starting to affect the offense just a little bit, as that time their coach chose to roll them out on the perimeter, and Lockhart's still able to put pressure on them.
Well, the good thing, Lockhart's able to keep the Wolves out of the end zone as they will be forced to punt. And back to punt for the Wolves will be Josh Gill. And back deep for the Lions to receive, it's going to be number 31, Deontay Jackson. Now, will they kick it to him or not? Or were Josh Gill just trying to kick it out the end zone? That's going to be a low snap. Gill will get a kick away, kicks it off towards the right side. That's going to take a bounce inside the five and into the end zone. And that'll be a touchback.
And thank goodness for that.
They had a man on the spot. Trying to catch the young man's number that was out there for the Wolves.
That was number zero.
That's going to be Darian Brown.
TD, I hope he gets tired before the game's over.
So do I, because he's everywhere. He's on offense, defense.
Oh, here we go, 11:36. Here in the Adam and Sons AC and Heating second quarter.
So Lockhart's last drive stalled around the 45. They'll be starting this time on their 20-yard line. 80 yards to go to try to tie up this game.
And that'll be a fake handoff to McKinney, and Dickens comes around the left side, stiffs arm a defender.
There's a stiff arm and then there's a plant. And he planted number 12 in the turf with that big right hand.
Second and five.
Of course, want to welcome up here next to us on the broadcast set we're at is Mr. Kyle Moody, editor for the Lockhart Post Register. Inside handoff to McKinney, sidesteps the defender, and he'll pick up a first down all the way to the 31-yard line.
And pick up your Lockhart Post Register next Monday, and you'll be able to catch all the details from the game.
It's on Thursday.
Thursday.
Lockhart Professor doing a great job covering the football game tonight.
And looks like it's going to be a two-back set. We've seen quarterback power out of this.
First down and 10 for the Lions. Dickens gets the snap. Fakes a handoff to Travion Hopkins. Comes around the near side. Got room to run. And looks like Dickens will pick up another first down.
And there's a flag on the play.
Oh, no.
I tell you what, Big Brady Stevenson had a great block on the edge. I thought he did a great job of holding his block. Looked like the referee thought he had just a little too much jersey in his hands. And that's going to move the Lions back 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
And that is going to be holding on the Lions. And unfortunately, that was a first down run by Dickens. And from the spot of the foul, looks like it'll probably be first down and 15. And we could do a couple of quick scores around the district. At Pflugerville, it is Bastrop Bears 14, the Panthers 14. And Leander Rouse, Liberty Hill Panthers 14, Rouse Raiders 7. And Elgin, still no score has been posted. It is 0-0, Piper Warriors versus Hallettsville. San Antonio Veterans Memorial, still no score. They got a 7:30 p.m. start. And it's no score with Kerrville and Marble Falls. Dickens drops back. Looking to throw the ball deep. Got Deontay Jackson unable to hang on to or get it out there.
You know,
just a little bit too far ahead.
He used that term one step away. He was about half a step away from having that one and picking up a big first down for the Lions.
I can see them coming back to that, though, Nick, here before the game's over.
You see that X on the field on the 40? I feel like coaches just throw it right at that X. He'll be there. Yeah, when you have a close miss like that, coach, you definitely think about coming back to it.
Yeah, so that'll bring up second down and 15. It's time to hand the ball off to Travion Hopkins going around the right side. He cuts it upfield, runs over a wolf.
Good run, good run.
Yeah, great job by Hopkins as he eliminates the penalty yardage and then picks up some more.
All the way down to the 36. Now that'll be third down and 5. Third down and 4, long 4 it is.
And we talked about it earlier, putting yourself in third and manageable is going to be a big deal tonight. Going up against a team with the offense as potent as Davenport. Yes.
And just like last year, Travion Hopkins just comes in for maybe a couple of plays on offense, but does the job whenever he gets the ball in his hands.
Third short, short here.
And that'll be a handoff to McKinney. He'll cut it upfield, gets towards midfield, and another big first down for the Lockhart Lions.
He's got the first down. I don't know, TD, I see the offensive line for the Lions wearing down the Davenport D-line. They look tired out there.
They do. It's only the second quarter, and they've all got their hands on their hips. Definitely.
That's one advantage of playing a 4A school. They don't have the numbers that a 5A school does, usually does.
So first down and 10 at the 49 in Wolf territory. Quick pass out to Gage Deutsch. He'll make the turn. Heads upfield.
And I tell you what, Coach, that's definitely usually true, but I think with Davenport being a new school, they've got pretty good participation. I did a quick count before the game, and they have 50 players on their roster.
And I was telling Sarge, they're going to be 5A next time around.
And that's a big first down catch by Gage Deutsch. Ball's placed at the 43-yard line, and they'll fake the pitch to McKinney. Dickens will cut it upfield. And great job making an initial hit in the backfield, C.J. Tanner. While number 7, Marcus Brew Adams comes in to make the tackle on Dickens.
It's a beautiful fake pitch, but they weren't fooled on the backside. They stayed at home, brought him down after a gain of just 2.
They sure weren't. Dickens able to pick up 2 yards. That'll bring up second down and 8. As once again, the Lions are methodically moving the ball down the field, unlike the Wolves who are with 2 quick strikes and 2 touchdowns. Inside handoff to McKinney. He runs into the back of his lineman.
Ran into a brick wall.
He'll push forward. He'll lose about 0.5 yards on there, so that'll bring up 3rd down and 9.5.
Another big 3rd down.
Well, he went back 2 or 3 and then did a good job to just push his head forward, keep those legs driving, and kind of try to get back to the line of scrimmage as that was blown up.
Yeah, and a great job by the front line of the defensive line for the Wolves as they were able to stand up the right side of the line for the Lions. And McKinney had nowhere to go. As Coach mentioned, the brick wall was right in front of him.
They've got 8 men in the box stacked up against the run.
They'll fake the handoff to McKinney, dropping back. That's going to be a screen pass to McKinney, or fakes the handoff to Jackson. And once again, that's going to bring up another 4th down for the Lions. This one's going to be 4th down and 6.
And in the same area of the field, we're in that gray area. See if... Yep, offense is going to go for it. Ocampo's not coming on the field. So this is probably the most pivotal play so far the first half for the Lions, as they desperately need to make up the 7 points that the Wolves are ahead.
Especially after making the stop on the Wolves and forcing them to punt on 4th and long to get the ball back. Dickens gets the snap, drops back, throwing deep to Jackson. Oh. And in and out of the hands of Jackson.
Beautiful protection by the offensive line, the Lockhart on that play, giving Dickens all the time in the world, and he lays one out. And that is the 3rd time that they have had a very close miss downfield. 2 of them to Jackson, 1 of them to Gathen. So, like Coach said, you got to think they're going to keep coming back to that.
It was there, TD. It was there.
Great effort by the Lockhart Lions offense. Unfortunately, they give the ball right back to the Wolves on a turnover on downs. And the Bulls will have the ball 1st down and 10 at their own 34-yard line. Hamlin comes out. Got a man in motion coming across the line of scrimmage. They'll hand the ball up the middle to number 14.
Guess who made the tackle?
Golden with the carry. Looks like Derek Rivas, if I'm correct.
Rivas.
Rivas and Trent Holcomb in on the stop.
Rivas, the defensive player of the game last week, the One Ghost Fitness defensive player of the game, played an incredible game and was just getting real penetration.
As we mentioned, the only time he wasn't in the play was when he forgot to go out on defense. So that'll bring up second down and nine after the one-yard run. Hamlin drops back, throws it out there, got the receiver wide open. The catch is going to be made. He'll break one arm tackle before he's hit and knocked out of bounds on the far side of the field.
And a good job of play calling by the Davenport coach as he brings a rub route out there on the outside where they're able to pick off the defender and get into the soft spot on the field.
Trey Brown in on the stump.
Yeah, there was definitely an opening there, TD.
David Miller with the catch and run. And the Wolves have first down and 10 at the 49-yard line in Wolf territory. Hand off to number 14, Goldston. Or Golden, and he'll get across the line of scrimmage, and he'll pick up about 6 yards.
Ramos and Gathens on the stop that time.
Second and five.
I tell you what, number 25 had a hold of him in the backfield, but he was able to break out of that tackle and push forward for a big gain.
Hamlin gets a snap, drops back, takes it, tucks it in, and Trent Holcomb comes in from the blind side and picks up another sack. And that'll be a big loss for the Wolves.
And the visual effect of the Lockhart pressure and the hits on the quarterback can be seen as he's moving around just a little bit slower on the field. And you got to think if you keep pressuring him, you take away that passing attack at Davenport, you might have a chance to start bottling him up here.
Well, and eventually he's going to give up the ball also, TD.
And he does have a knee brace on his left leg. So that'll bring up third down and eight. And they'll fake the inside handoff and a great catch for a big first down for the Wolves.
Number 13, great tackle.
Dante Singletary on the carry, on the catch.
No huddle.
This time they'll hand the ball off up the middle to Golden, and he'll pick up a good chunk of yards all the way down to the 34-yard line. And that'll bring up second down and five.
And you know, Serge, I hate to highlight it, but I think it's an important point for some of our young men watching the game. Lockhart missing Quavon Reese here on defense.
And that's going to be a pitch out to Golden. He brings it around the near side. Jackson's going to be right there behind him. And also making the hit, it's going to be Bart Key. But that'll be a first down by Shaston Golden. And the ball's going to be marked at the 26-yard line.
Expect Lockhart to bring pressure here, TD.
Tell you what, Jackson and Key got out the peanut butter on that one, and they made a sandwich.
Yeah, empty backfield as Hamlin drops back. Quick throw, and that catch is going to be made. And coming up to make the hit, it's going to be Deontay Jackson.
Beautiful open field tackle there by Jackson.
Textbook on the reception is Emmett Griman.
Going fast here.
Second and six. Picking up the tempo as Hamlin drops back. Looking to throw. And great job by Bart Key. Poking that one out of the hands of the receiver.
And I tell you what, he was wide open when the quarterback threw the ball. Bart Key closing the gap and getting his hand there to save 6 points for the Lions. Great play by the cornerback.
Great recovery there, TD.
Yes, great play by the junior cornerback.
Talk about making up ground. He was about 3 or 4 yards behind, and then he was right in his face by the time the ball got there.
That's going to bring up third down and five for the Wolves. And we could almost rest assured this is going to be four down territory if they don't make it here on third down. Golden in the backfield with Hamlin. And he'll get the handoff coming around the near side, and he'll dive forward, and he'll pick up the first down all the way to the 14-yard line. And that'll bring up first down and 10. Hamlin gets the snap, fakes the handoff, drops back to throw. They're going to call pass interference on Deontay Jackson.
I tell you what, Trey Brown had a bead on that ball. That was very close to an interception in the end zone for Trey Brown. Just not quite able to get to it and also kind of making running into Jackson as he got there.
The officials are talking and trying to decide.
Now, it looked like there was a little bit of contact, but nothing super obvious going on down there. Of course, you know, I'm always in the kitchen with a little bit of that home cooking.
Okay. They're going to call defensive holding. So that'll be a 5-yard penalty, but That'll make it an automatic first down, and the 5 yards will make it first down and goal to goal from inside the 10.
Trying to figure out where the previous spot was.
If they take a look here on the near side, they'll be able to see that it was at the 14.
That's what I'm thinking. If they look over there at that down marker, he's standing right where it was at. Good job, too, by the chain crew there to just hang tight.
Yes. So first down and goal to goal from inside the 10 at the 7-yard line.
Lockhart definitely has made a goal line stand a few times already this season.
You're going to have to come up with a big one to keep this within a one-score game. Hamlin gets the snap.
Quarterback.
Make the handoff. Throw it out there. And a beautiful catch made in the end zone by number 19.
And that's a one-handed grab.
Yeah, Kyler Payne.
Excellent catch.
So the Wolves go up by 2 scores on Lockhart, 20-7. And you know, Sarge, Coach, this will be something interesting to see, as this is going to be the first time this year that the Lockhart Lions have really faced adversity, had, you know, kind of some close spots in some other games, but this is really the first time that the Lions have been down by more than a touchdown all year. So I'll be interested to see how the team reacts. I'll be interested to be looking at the body language over the next quarter and see how Lockhart answers this.
Yes, and extra point is good. It is 21-7. We're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back with more Lockhart Lion football right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
If you're looking for a custom-made tumbler for yourself or as a gift, from pro sports, college, high school, and inspirational tumblers, here at Shimmer Me Tumblers, we can create what you're looking for. We can create just about any design or style to give your tumbler a one-of-a-kind look. So, look no further than Shimmer Me Tumblers, designed by Blanca and Emilio Juarez. You can find us on Facebook and on TikTok, or you can email us at shimmermetumblers0@gmail.com.
And we are back, and a big difference from this last drive for the Wolves. It wasn't a quick strike drive. It was more of a methodical drive down the field. They were able to get the ball into the end zone on a beautiful catch by number 19, Kyler Payne. Extra point is good, and with 4:29 left to go here in the changing faces, the Adam and Sons AC and Heating second quarter, we have a 21-7 lead by the Wolves over the Lions, as Gill will be coming in to kick the ball away. Once again, Sean McKinney on the near side, Deontay Jackson on the far side, and that's going to be a pooch kick that's going to be fielded by Travion Hopkins. He's going to bring it upfield, puts his shoulder down, and he'll get it all the way up to the 40-yard line, where the Lockhart Lions are going to have the ball first down and 10.
Tell you what, wasn't a whole lot of space there, but Hopkins definitely made do with what he had, getting 10 yards on the return. Eight Hopkins, as they're calling him on the other side.
Eight Hopkins, all right.
He said eight Hopkins. That's okay. A lot of people still just call me Dunn.
Well, when he runs the ball, it's like eight of them running the ball anyway. So I think they got a good point going on right there, eight Hopkins.
All right, Lockhart's going to come out in their single back set. It'll be McKinney back there with Dickens. Three wide receivers.
Good tough run there.
And Sean McKinney doing what Sean McKinney does, which is just continue to push that ball down the field. Picking up 4 yards on that play, going to bring up second and six for the Lions. Ball on the 44-yard line. Still same personnel, no subs for the Lions. Looking to go quick here. And Davenport was ready for that one,
yes,
as they
sir.
Brought the blitz off the edge.
Nothing there.
Looked like a design run blitz, and they were able to get McKinney for a loss of, call it a half yard. So call it third and seven for the Lions, as they await the play from Coach Gilbert on the sidelines. Going to be trips out here to the near side of the field.
One receiver on top.
And Dickens takes a snap. Plenty of time. Surveys the field. Gets the ball to Blake Herzog in the flat. Herzog with a move. Cuts back to the inside, and he's going to move the chains for the Lions as he moves the ball to the opposite 45-yard line.
I'll tell you what.
Yeah, great move by Blake Herzog. Seeing that ball into his hands once again. and just turning around and hitting straight upfield.
And Herzog mistakes the field judge for the line judge and tosses the ball downfield to him.
It happens.
Lockhart up to the line quick here. And that's going to be a handoff to McKinney. Gets away from a tackler in the backfield. Busts through the middle. Going around the far side all the way down to the 20 before he's ran out of bounds at the 18-yard line. And that's going to be a 26-yard gain for Sean McKinney.
You see at the end there, TD, he told number 11, go ahead and bring it. See what you. Let me see what you have.
Yeah. Well, I tell you, he's definitely not one to shy away from contact. Never has been. A lot of time he runs kind of like Walter Payton as opposed to looking for the open field. Sometimes he's looking for the next man to lay the boom on.
Yeah, like I said.
So Lockhart not giving Davenport a chance to sub here. Keeping the same personnel in the game, going quick, and just missing on a pass across the middle to Blake Herzog is Dickens.
And we talked about it before, 9 times out of 10, McKinney's not looking to go right of you or left of you. He's looking to go right through you.
Yep.
One of the few running backs that you'll see out there looking for contact.
Yeah, so I really like what Coach is doing here. By not subbing anybody out, he's really getting a chance to wear Davenport down. Now, they're not going super fast here, but all they've got to do is get their play in. If they see Davenport start to sub, then they just switch right to the hurry up, get to the line.
Good point, TD.
It's going to be second and 10, ball from the 18. Dickens going to keep it himself up the middle. Breaks the tackle, sheds another one, and he's going to be in for a Lockhart Lions touchdown. Put it on the board. That's 6 more points for the Lockhart Lions, and they cut the deficit in half, pinning the extra point. It'll be 14-21. Davenport still up on Lockhart. We'll have 2 minutes 38 seconds left to go here in the first half.
Yeah, if you're at the Lounge Sports Bar, watching the official watch party of Lockhart Lions football on the Lions Pride Sports broadcast. Hold them up high as that is another Lockhart Lion touchdown.
And the clock runs there for quite a few ticks after the play is a 4 seconds runoff. And it looks like they will call an official timeout, most likely to get the clock corrected. Thank goodness.
I got him. I got him over here.
Talking about home cooking.
That's telling we need about 3 more minutes on the clock. So Lockhart will get the ball to come out in the second half. Stay tuned with us as we'll be bringing your Kreitz Market halftime show.
We still have 2:23 left in this second quarter.
Looks like they're trying to get the clock up. If not, the head referee just wants to have a little conversation with Gage Deutsch down there.
How you doing, son? How's your mom and dad?
We going to Kreitz Market after this?
And looks like they're going to put around 20 seconds back on the clock. And the extra point is good, bringing the Lockhart Lions to within 1 score. And keep in mind, Davenport did start off with the football. Lockhart will get it to start the second half. And I think everyone at home is probably the same as me. They've got their fingers crossed that in the second half we see them come out on kick return. We see Quavon Reese back there for the Lions.
Yes, and chances are they're probably not going to kick it to him anyway, but just to have him out there is just going to be that extra weapon that we're going to have offensively and defensively, especially on the defensive side of things, as the Wolves were able to break off on 2 large runs. And it's going to be interesting to see when they put Quavon Reese out there, see how well this defense is going to be able to maneuver themselves with 2:40 left to go.
So one of the things I like the most about what we've seen so far tonight is in games past, we've kind of seen one receiver get the ball here and there, but Dickens starting to spread the ball around when he's passing. Herzog catching several. Gage Deutsch has several. McKinney's caught one out of the backfield, and several shots deep for Deontay Jackson. Unable to complete one of those, but they were razor thin, and I definitely look for the Lions to come back to that as soon as they're back on the offensive side of the football.
Big thing for the Lockhart Lions here. Defensively, they have to stop Davenport and get this ball back to get themselves an opportunity to tie this ball game and go into halftime with a tie. As you mentioned, TD, they will have the ball to start the second half.
And a weird-looking kick as you got a
spiral. Oh, he touched it. That's a live ball.
It is a live ball, but looked like Davenport was able to get onto it. Tell you what, that's one of the oddest kicks that you see with the tail of the ball pointing towards the ground with the ball in a perfect spiral flying down the field. Looks like Davenport will take the ball over on their 25-yard line.
Yeah, my apologies. I'm the one running the camera right now as my wife headed on down to the concession stand. So I missed that last play.
And so this defensive series is going to be crucial for the Lions. You just pull within one score. It is going to be super important to keep Davenport out of the end zone here just before the second half.
And a great stop up front.
Looks like they're going to – I was surprised about the offensive approach they're using there. Well, they're going no huddle, though. Back to pass.
Lockhart brings the blitz, almost gets to him, but he's able to get the ball out to number 19 in the flat.
There's a fumble.
And there was a fumble on the play.
He went out of bounds.
And the ball did go out of bounds, but he did pick up a first down before he did fumble that ball. So that's going to be first and 10, ball on the 35-yard line.
That's one adjustment that Lockhart defense kind of do, that stopping that tailback coming out of the backfield on those pass routes.
And that ball thrown just too deep for the receiver to get to, as number 19 was the intended receiver. He was covered by Brown and Fabian Rivera as the pressure was coming on that one from Zakiya Gathens.
Exactly, TD. Great pressure there.
You know, I definitely do like this Davenport offense. I like the pump fakes left and right before they go downfield, really mixing it up and doing a good job of keeping the Lions guessing as to where they're going to go with the ball. And a run up the middle. It's going to be shut down for nothing as the entire defensive line and two outside linebackers in on that tackle for Lockhart. That's going to be a short gain. Going to bring up third down and 9.
Now this is going to be a crucial play for the Lockhart Lions defense as they need to keep this one.
Well, then you start to wonder if you can get the ball back. Clock at a minute and a half and running.
We stop him here. Got to definitely call a timeout.
Yeah. And he's going to take snap. He's back to pass. He's looking across the middle. Hits him on the short flat route. He's going to pick up a first down. And he's going to get out of bounds, which will stop the clock with a minute and 12 seconds as he moves the sticks to the Lockhart side of the field. That's going to be first and 10 Davenport at the Lockhart 46-yard line.
Big conversion by the Davenport Wolves. As that keeps the ball in their hands.
With a minute 12 on the clock.
And it's going to be three receivers up top for the quarterback, one to the short side of the field. And
screen,
it's going to be
screen.
A quick screen out to the edge. And Trey Brown sniffs it out. And he's going to tackle him for about a 2-yard loss as he's joined in there by several other Lions on the play. Good job of gang tackling. But once again, that bubble screen, you just can't do that against Trey Brown because he's going to blow it up every time. He reads it very well. So two receivers to either side of the field for this play. Quarterback's going to be dropping back, looking to pass. Pressure coming up the middle. He gets out of the pocket. Still looking. Throws one deep down the field. Too high, intended for number 19. And the quarterback takes another hit on that play. He was looking for a flag. Thought maybe it was a little late.
And that'll stop the clock. Deontay Jackson with a great pressure out there.
And another big third down for the Davenport Wolves here. Lockhart gets yet another chance to try to stop him and get him off the field. Clock will start on the snap of the ball.
And it looks like Lockhart's going to call a timeout.
Good call. Good call.
Yep. Get him a little breather. Get some water in him. And
we're going to keep it right here as we have about 29 seconds left to go for the Christ Market halftime show.
Well, and I tell you what, on that last play breaking up that screen was Trey Brown. And I just want to take a moment to kind of acknowledge the Brown family who experienced tragedy and loss this last year as Joshua Brown and his son Jacob were tragically killed in a car accident. But today at Navarro Elementary, they held a ceremony where they planted a 10-year-old magnolia tree in honor of Jacob Brown. And I know Mr. Stephen Brown and his wife Alexis were there in attendance today. And just want to say our thoughts and prayers continue to go out to the Brown family for the losses that they've endured. And, you know, I also endured a loss, as I sure miss Josh Brown. He was an all-star reporter.
Matter of fact, they're right here to the left side of us right now.
That's right.
Right here to the left side.
You know, talking about how Josh was the all-star reporter for the Lockhart Lions for Max Preps, Steven has recently taken over that, and that's what he's doing right there right now, is he is entering the scores and stats on Max Preps for the Lockhart Lions. So shout out to the Brown family. We'll be in our thoughts. All right, big third down. Going to be third and 11. Ball on the 47-yard line. He's got two receivers to either side of the field. Lockhart giving a good cushion to these receivers. And another screen. Gatherin sniffs it out, but he's able to get away from him and move the ball. Going to be fourth down. Davenport's going to try to hurry up as he was brought down inbounds. Clock ticking down to 15 seconds. And they're subbing players off the field. Going to be down to 10 seconds.
And right now, it doesn't look like Lockhart's going to get the ball back, but they do have to stop the Wolves.
5 seconds to go. They'll get the snap off. He once again rolls out of the pocket. He's going to launch one deep down the sideline, and that's going to be once again over the intended receiver number one. So that's going to do it for the first half. Davenport Wolves leading your Lockhart Lions 21-0. Here at Davenport High School in outside of San Antonio, Texas.
21-14.
21-14.
21-14. Goodness gracious.
All right, so that's going to do it for the first half as we head off into the Kreitz Market halftime show, where we're going to take a look at the Roaring Lion Band and your Davenport Wolves band. But right now, we're going to cut off our mic and turn on the crowd mic. But before that, let's head on out for a Kreitz Market show right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
Smoke Texas Barbecue. What's smoke?
All right, we're good.
Thank you. Thank you. Smoke Texas Barbecue puts smiles on faces. Since 1900, Kreitz Mark has been putting smiles on faces with every bite of Smoke Texas Barbecue. Located off of Highway 183 at 619 North Colorado Street in Lockhart, Texas, fifth-generation owner Keith Schmidt continues the tradition of providing the best barbecue in Texas with its award-winning varieties of beef, sausage, and pork meats. All Kreitz Barbecue is Post Oak smoked to perfection under pitmaster Roy Perez's watchful eye in Kreitz Market's hallowed brick pits. Let Kreitz cater your party or event. Kreitz can assemble a complete barbecue dinner and sides for any event in Central Texas. To get a quote on catering, Kreitz Barbecue catering manager Weston Black can be reached at 512-398-2361. That's 512-398-2361. Kreitz Market opens 7 days a week, Monday through Saturday from 10:30 a.m. to 8 p.m. and on Sundays from 10:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. You can find out more about Kreitz Market on their Facebook page or go to kreitzmarket.com. That's www.kreitzmarket.com.
TD, you're right. Reese had to sit out the first half of that incident that happened last week against Lehman, but he's back this second half. First and 10 Lions.
All right, go ahead.
All right, we'll see if they come out in the one back or two back. Looks like it's going to be one back. And they'll start with two receivers. That's going to be Deutsch and Garcia here on the wide side of the field. Up top by himself will be Herzog. Hines for the 25-yard line. It's going to be a handoff to McKinney. Big hole off tackle with a big stiff arm. Comes around the outside and looks like McKinney's going to pick up 8.5 yards.
Great run. Great strong run by that young man.
Good first run to start out the second half for McKinney.
And go back what you're saying, TD. It's the penalties that has been killing us. It's not so much Davenport. It's the dang penalties against us.
Well, I don't know. Davenport's got a lot of yellow in their stands, and I've seen a lot of yellow in the fields today. All right, so Dickens going to come up to the ball. McKinney offset to his right. He's got trips up top. Got Deutsch alone on the bottom side. Dickens looking to go deep. Slings it. Got a man open, ooh, but unable to connect with him. Both Quavon Reese and Jackson, for my judgment, probably a little too close. You don't usually have designs where you have two receivers within 3 yards of each other that far down the field.
Busted route by somebody there.
Yeah, Dickens wanted to go deep with the home run ball there, unable to connect. That's going to bring up third down and caught a long two for the Lions. And we'll have trips down here to the short side of the field with Deutsch, Garcia, and Herzog. Bart Key will be up top by himself. And the snap to Dickens. It's going to be a keeper. He's looking to go on the right side. Runs into traffic, but keeps his feet going and is going to pick up enough yards for the first down. You know, Coach, we talk about Sean McKinney and his yards after catch or yards after contact. Ashton Dickens showing up.
Yes, sir. It gets stronger as the game goes on. Defensive end for the Davenport Wolves did a great job of staying at home, but he just Ashton just ran over.
Yeah, you know, it's difficult when you stay home, you do your job, and you're still unable to make the tackle.
You're in good position, and you just get run over.
And it's going to be an inside handoff to McKinney. He's going to run into the pile, but squirt out the other side and move the ball forward for a gain of 3 yards. Going to bring up second and 7. That brings the ball out to the 40-yard line for the Lions.
I still think McKinney runs like he's 250 pounds.
And they look to the sideline for the call from Coach Gilbert. Comes in. And McKinney will be offset to the left. Got a tight end in the ball game. And it's going to be a quarterback run around the left side. Dickens unable to get the edge. And he's going to lose a couple yards on that play.
Good job on defense, number 17 for the Davenport Wolves.
Yeah, they just did exactly what you asked your defense to do. They kept stretching out to the sideline and ends up in a loss of 4 for the Lions. Going to bring up third down 11. Ball on the 36-yard line. Lockhart trailing the Wolves 14-21. Lockhart sorely needs to move the ball down the field and try to make up those 7 points they're down. Definitely don't want to give the ball back to Davenport without having gotten something for their efforts. Lockhart has converted on a couple long third downs tonight. One on a pass to Herzog. He'll drop back, and he's going to be sacked for a big loss. That's number 25 on the sack for Davenport.
One stray shot at the quarterback. Nobody picked him up.
And that's Judge Erickson, and he was one of the captains at the beginning of the game, coming from his left defensive end spot. So that's going to bring out Omar Ocampo, who will be standing in his own 12 to punt the ball away.
That's what happens sometimes when you go empty. There's nobody back there to protect the quarterback.
And you'll have number one Emmett Greeman back to receive the punt. He'll be standing around his own 38-yard line. We'll see if Ocampo can get a hold of one. Low snap, gets it up, gets the kickoff clean, and it is a high one. They're calling kill to stay away from it. Going to take a bit of a Lockhart bounce. And looks like the ball's going to roll down and be down right around the 35-yard line. And that's where the Davenport Wolves will take over. So we'll keep it here as they change sides. Lockhart unable to get much going on their first series. Total net was negative 6 yards on that first series here in the second half for the Lions. Got to think they want to do better than that. One thing that's definitely different in this second half, you'll see on the short side of the field, number 4, Quavon Reese is back in the game at his cornerback position. In the first half, we saw Davenport definitely attacking that side of the field. And we'll see if Quavon Reese is able to make his presence felt here. Lockhart definitely playing the pass as Ramos is usually on the line. He's playing back. And good job by Ramos to get out there and force that back inside. But not before the runner was able to pick up 6 yards. That was Zakiya Gathens on the tackle.
Once again, hurry up offense by the Davenport Wolves.
And he'll throw the quick pass out on the edge to number 1. That's going to be good for a first down, and that'll move the sticks and move the ball out to the 49-yard line. Davenport 1 yard from getting into Lockhart territory. First down, Davenport. And the announcer for Davenport said Gage Deutsch caught that ball. Wrong number 1, wrong side of the ball. And Lockhart jumps, and it looks like they're going to catch him off sides.
And the receiver on this side was moving, but of course, we're the ones that get caught.
And that was Rivas that jumped the gun just a little bit early for the Lions. But Rivas is saying false start. He's saying they moved, and that's why it came off. We'll see what the call is as they meet at midfield for discussion.
He saw a movement out of the corner of his eye.
I hope so. And they're going to call it against Lockhart, so that'll move the ball 5 yards. It'll be 1st and 5 from the 46-yard line for the Wolves.
Can anybody tell me how many penalties Davenport has?
I do not know. But I tell you what, there towards the end of the first half, the Lockhart defense definitely showed up there with a couple big stops and really did a great job to hold Davenport and keep him out of the end zone there at the end of the first half to keep it at a 1-score game. And from the gun, he'll get the snap, and he's going to give the ball off inside. Same play they've scored twice on. And he's going to rumble downfield for a 33-yard gain. So for the third time tonight, we see the run inside for Davenport getting him big yardage. The ball's going to be on the 15-yard line. Davenport now in the red zone. Same play again.
This time Ramos is there.
Yep, Lockhart does a lot better at containing number 14 this time as Ramos comes up with the tackle, and they're going to have a short gain. Two yards, going to bring up 2nd and 8.
.7:47, .45 left in the third quarter.
And so a bit of time ticking away here, and that's number 14, Shaston Golden, on the run on that last play, and most of the big runs. And going to see jet sweep motion, but it's going to go back to Golden. Same play again up the middle, and guess what? Man, it sure works for Davenport as they get into the end zone again.
It opened up wide
open. They're going to separate it to a 2-score game once again. So clearly Lockhart unable to make the adjustments to stop that play, as that is the third time that Davenport has scored with that play. So that'll be 28-14, pinning the extra point. The Lions will be back down 2 again, and in a hole, the Lions are going to have to claw their way out. And I want to give a shout-out to everyone watching down there at the lounge. Maybe if we can get you guys to make a little bit of noise for us, we can rally the team. And the extra point is good, so that is going to make it 28-14 here with 7 minutes and 28 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Both teams still have all 3 timeouts. Nobody's used one here in the second half. So when Davenport came out to kick off for the second half, they kicked the ball out of the end zone. Their first 2 kicks of the game were pooch kicks. We did see Quavon Reese come in on the return team, and then they definitely elected not to kick it to him. And we'll see if we get the same thing again. You know, I got to say, Coach, if I got a kicker who's got the leg to kick it out of the back of the end zone, I don't think I bother with pooch kicks.
Yeah. You're right there, TD, especially with the people we have over there returning kicks for us. There's a little breeze behind him, so that's why he gives him an advantage to get the ball in the end zone.
And so we'll see Jackson and Reese heading back deep again. The next two up men from them are going to be McKinney and Hopkins. And that's number 88, Josh Gill, handling the kicking duties for Davenport as he lines his kickoff team up. And Gill gets a boot into it, and that one's going to be another deep one that Lockhart's going to let go and bounce out of the back of the end zone as it lands about 8 yards deep in the back of the end zone. So that's going to be another touchback for Gill, and Lockhart will start this next drive on the 25-yard line, down by two touchdowns to these Davenport Wolves.
Whoever has the whistle, will you please stop blowing the whistle? The game officials have asked that you stop blowing the whistle.
Looks like they've got an inadvertent whistle in the crowd being blown, and that could cause a 15-yard penalty on the home team if it's coming from that side.
Well, Sarge, I thought they were just whistling at me.
No wonder our defense is stopping before the play's over.
So they'll come out in an empty set. First time we've seen the empty set tonight with five wide receivers. Got two men in motion. They'll have to both get set for a full second, and that's going to, well, maybe a couple flags here, one for false start.
False start.
And lucky they didn't get us with the illegal procedure as the players had barely gotten set when they snapped it. And the Lockhart crowd giving it to the refs on what was a pretty obvious false start. You get down, emotions start running high.
We have to be ready.
They're going to stay in the empty set. So it's going to be first and 15 from the 20. McKinney motions into the backfield. Dickens pitches it outside to him. McKinney gets the edge, but he cuts it back inside and does a good job to fight and fight. He gets the penalty yardage back and gets back almost to the original line of scrimmage. So that's going to bring up second and 11 on that gain of four.
All right, gentlemen, I'm back.
All right, we got the Sarge back.
Well, special thanks, TD. Always ready to step in and take over when needed. So that's how we do it here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. We're all versatile. So a second down and 11 for the Lions. McKinney goes to the backfield with Dickens. Dickens gets a snap, drops back, throw it out. Has Nate Garcia unable to hang on to it, but a big hit by the Wolf defender.
Number 17.
Yeah. And that's Singletary. A tough catch to make as Singletary brings a big hit on Garcia, just got him right in the ribs, unable to hold on to that ball. That's the first time Garcia's been targeted tonight, and that ball was going to be short of the first down.
Pass was a little bit too high.
And the breeze starting to pick up just a little bit here at Davenport Stadium.
Dickens gets the snap, throws it over the middle to Deontay Jackson. He'll break free. Going down, crosses midfield to the 40. A foot race, 30, 20, 10. Nice stutter step and Jackson into the end zone on a long touchdown pass and run.
And Jackson puts the Steve Nash crossover on number zero just outside the goal line before he walks in for 6 points. Darian Brown definitely had some speed, and he had an angle on Jackson, but he may have had the angle, but Jackson broke his ankles as he took it in. If you're at the Lounge Sports Bar, raise one up for the Lockhart Lions.
That's another Lockhart Lion touchdown as Omar Ocampo will come in to kick the extra point try. Once again, Gabe Deutsch on the hold. Trent Holcomb, the deep snapper. Snap is back, the hold is down, the kick is up, and it is good. And the Lions are back within one touchdown.
Deutsch was unable to get the ball turned around and laces out, but no matter, Ocampo still puts it through. Looks like there was a penalty on the play. And they're going to decline it.
Going to go against Davenport.
And so with that, Lockhart brings it back to within seven. Lockhart taking very little time to score there. About a minute and a half at the most off the clock in that drive, and that's going to bring up 6 minutes and 32 seconds left to play here in the Adam & Sons Heating third quarter.
Change of Faces Barbershop third quarter.
TD, I think Jackson's a little bit faster than his brother Curtis.
But great move by Jackson. As soon as he made that catch, he was able to break that arm tackle of the Davenport Wolf defender.
That's right. He knew right where that defender was going to be and just how to turn around, getting those inches, those precious inches of space that allowed him to break free and get down the field for six.
And when you get Jackson out in the open field all by himself, one-on-one against any defender, I don't care who it is, you ain't going to get him.
No, sir.
And so we'll see Ocampo kicking into the wind.
What are the chances we see an onside kick right here, gentlemen?
I don't know. With how Davenport has played, I don't think I risk giving them the ball anywhere near this end of the field with how easily they've been able to score tonight.
Well, there goes that thought. No onside kick. That one's going to be caught right around the 22-yard line.
Too much.
And that one's going to be brought upfield all the way down to the 39-yard line.
And that's going to be a 17-yard return for Singletary.
Damian Rocha on the stop.
And so we'll see the Lockhart defense come out on the field. Every starter seems to be in the game. And Ramos up there at the line getting the big boys fired up. Now, we did see in the first half, Lockhart was able to get to the quarterback two times and put him on the ground and hit him a couple other times. You'd like to see him do the same thing here in the second half.
Hamlin gets the snap, fakes the handoff, throws it out to the flats. That one's going to be caught. Trey Brown in on the stop, along with Travion Hopkins.
And I have a conversation with Trey Brown's dad at halftime. I told him, I don't know why they keep trying to go out on the edge where Trey is. It's just not working for him.
He's going to eventually get one.
Well, and he said eventually that he thinks he's going to get a hat on the ball and put it on the ground if they keep trying it.
Yeah, great job of the defense on that last play.
2-yard gain. That brings up second down and 8. Dropping back to pass, and that one's going to be caught, but he'll be hit immediately after making a catch by Bart Key.
It's going to be third and short.
So Lockhart doing a good job to keep it in front of him, but the quick passing game stinging him for a few yards.
Third and 2.
Looks like Ramos will be coming off the edge. And he does indeed, and he makes the tackle, but not before he's able to get that first down.
Dog it. Yeah, great job by Ramos to get into the backfield just a little bit too late as Golden is able to get the first down for the Wolves.
Well, Ramos timed it right, didn't he?
He sure did.
He sure did, TD. Excellent job by Mr. Ramos.
And they let him come unblocked, too.
So here it is, first down and 10 for the Wolves at the 49-yard line in Wolf territory. Hamlin gets the snap, throws the ball over the middle. And that one's going to be caught after a beautiful hit by Trey Brown.
Great catch for number 1.
And it looked like Trey Brown knew he was about one step off from having a shot at grabbing that one.
And that'll be in line territory at the 34-yard line.
So while Davenport has been able to move the ball, Lockhart not making it easy on him.
Fakes the handoff up the middle. Beautiful strike to the open receiver.
And a good open field tackle by Bart Key on that one.
Looked like a slant there, TD.
That's Kyler Payne with the reception and Bart Key with the stop.
So first and 10 from the 11-yard line. And the quarterback will go down, and that's Rivas getting in there for the sack.
And I tell you what, TD and Coach, Davenport has done a great job containing Rivas today. They definitely don't want him to take over the ball game as he did against Lehman last week.
Well, and Rivas was in the backfield so fast on that play. Seemed like he came on delivery with the ball.
Well, it's helped them, TD, as they moved him from the defensive tackle position to the defensive end position.
And Davenport spreads it out now. He is. He's playing in a 9 technique outside of that tackle.
It's going to be a jet sweep coming around the near side.
Oh.
Oh, Deontay Jackson missing the block and a big hit by Bart Key.
And Bart Key's going to, looks like they're going to rule him down. Can't advance the fumble, so he'll be down at the spot of, well.
No, he was down when the ball came out, so that's going to be third down and short. Wolves do have an opportunity to pick up the first down.
You great if we could hold him here and maybe hold him to a field goal.
Golden gets the handoff, going around the left side, follows his blocker up through the middle and into the end zone for another Davenport touchdown.
We have a player down for Lockhart.
Davenport just refusing to let the Lions catch up to him in this game. As we have a player down, we'll go ahead and pan away. And we'll take a quick break here. You're watching Lockhart Lions football on Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. We'll be back with you here in just a moment.
That's Revis is down.
Changing Faces Barbershop has been serving the Lockhart and surrounding communities since 2009. Head barber and owner Lex Jennings and staff pride themselves on being a hip urban barbershop. For shaves, not only do we hit you with our precessional and trimmers, we offer a close shave and edge up with a straight razor. If you're really wanting to be pampered, let us give you one of our famous hot towel shaves. For cuts, Changing Face barbers are all top of their class and are able to pull off any style, whether it's a mohawk, classic cut, fade, taper, or design. We pride ourselves on our talent, our drive, and want to give our clients the best experience available. For all styles from the newest trends to old school cuts, our barbers here at Changing Faces have the skills to transform your look and feel. With over 10 years of combined experience, our barbers are on the cutting edge of the barber world. Come by one of our two locations, 2000 West San Antonio Street in Lockhart, Texas, and 900 Bug Lane Suite 115 in San Marcos, Texas. Or go to our website at cfbarbershop.com.
All right, and we're back after the injury timeout. Young man was able to get up and walk off the field underneath his own power. After the touchdown, the Wolves will be going for the extra point try as Gill comes in to kick the extra point.
And Gill perfect so far tonight on extra points.
Snap is back. The hold is down. The kick is up, and it is good.
Well, Lockhart really came after that one. Lockhart has had a blocked extra point on the year in the first game of the year. Since then, we've been unable to get our hands on the ball.
And right now, we're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back with more Lockhart Lions football right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
We know it can be hard to follow a dream, even harder to sustain one. However, at Changing Faces Barber Academy, we not only understand, but welcome those walking the path of their reveries. We make it our purpose to teach beyond just a skill set of cutting hair. In fact, we want to help with communication dexterity, give you the abilities to not only build clientele, but to be able to build off one. A good barber is the customer service he or she gives. And that is the mission here at Changing Faces Barber Academy. If you are interested in making a career of becoming a barber, you can visit our website at cfbarberacademy.com. Or stop on by at 900 Bug Lane Suite 115 in San Marcos, Texas.
All right, and we are back after the Davenport Wolf touchdown. It is Wolves 35, Lockhart Lions 21. I want to thank everybody for tuning in and watching tonight's broadcast of Lockhart Lions football right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. I want to give everybody an opportunity to enter the drawing to be one of two lucky Lions to win either two free tickets or three free tickets to next week's homecoming football game at Lions Field, courtesy of Kent Riddle Properties and the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. That one's going to be fielded. Oh, well, Quavon Reese thought about taking that one and decided to let it go. Is how you're going to be able to enter that drawing. All you got to do is type in the comment section, "Go Lions," and you are automatically entered into the drawing. So, and that drawing will be taking place this Monday afternoon at 8 p.m. And also, courtesy of Kent Riddle Properties, we do have five homecoming moms to give away as well. And if you want to enter your name into that drawing, all you got to do is type in the comment section, "Moms for me," and we'll have that drawing tomorrow night for five lucky Lion fans to win one of five moms, courtesy of Alexis Jennings and Kent Riddle Properties. Now it looks like we're going to have a little delay. There's a football in the end zone. All right, that one's going to be picked up. It's going to be first down and 10 for the Lions. The ball is at the 25-yard line. Dickens gets the snap, drops back, throws it out deep to Quavon Reese. Ooh. He has a defender right in front of him, and that looks like that could have been pass interference.
You know, and you almost always get the flag when the defender does not let the offensive player, you know, essentially he has no chance to come back for the ball because the defender's coming through his body.
And the defender did not turn around at all. Something similar to what they called on Deontay Jackson early in the first quarter.
And Lockhart coach is unhappy with that missed call.
So that'll bring up second down and 10. That's going to be a handoff to Sean McKinney going around the right side.
Picks up the first down.
And I've heard of a high step, but that was a long step, Sarge. As McKinney almost got tackled, reached and took one step that covered about 3 yards.
Yeah, Lockhart coach is still giving this poor referee a hard time over here.
He's letting him have it.
Oh, yes. Got to get the chain straight.
So they're going to say it was shy of the first down, so that's going to bring up second down or third down and one.
Well, they got first down up there.
And an official timeout's going to take place.
They're going to measure.
As the clock continues to run, they should have stopped this clock about 35 seconds ago.
And it's still running.
It's still running.
Third down and one. Lockhart. Wolves fans, on your feet. Third and short.
I tell you what, about a minute has ran off the clock.
Well, while the game clock kept running, the play clock was not, and they do not put time back on the clock despite the official timeout.
Now,
there we go.
Coach Gilbert pointed out, well, Coach May was pointing out the headlines.
He's going, what are you doing, guys? Come on, stop trying to steal my time. And that's the second time we've seen a big runoff happen. And that's not on the officials on the field either. It's most likely the clock operator.
Can't decide whether to have the popcorn or the sausage wrapped up.
But I know the feeling.
Once again, if you want to enter the drawing to be one of two lucky Lion fans, one to win two free tickets to next week's homecoming football game, and another one to win three free tickets to next week's homecoming game, all courtesy of Kent Riddle Property and the Lion Pride Sports Broadcast. All you have to do is in the comment section type in the words "Go Lions," and you'll be automatically entered into the drawing that's going to take place Monday night at 8 p.m. right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. And also, Kent Riddle Properties has got 5 moms to give away to 5 lucky Lion fans.
I thought you said five moms.
Five moms, courtesy of Alexis Jennings.
And it looks like they're going to go with their trip set.
All I got to do is in the comment section, type in the words "moms for me." And they put back a full minute on the clock, TD.
That's more than there was. It was at 3:23, and now it's at 3:40. We'll take it. We're going to need all the time we can get in this one.
Well, at least they gave us something back. So it's third down and one. Inside handoff to Sean McKinney. He'll get the first down and more. All the way to the 45-yard line.
And number 25 with a shoestring tackle that kept McKinney from getting a big game. That'll move the chains.
So that'll be a first down and 10 for the Lockhart Lions. This time they'll fake the inside handoff. Dickens will keep it, cut it upfield. And he'll get cross midfield all the way down to the 46-yard line in Wolf territory. And that'll bring up second down and 3.
And once again, that's number 25, Judge Erickson, on the tackle again. Erickson, golly, he's got to have about a third of the tackles for Davenport. He's not a very big and imposing outside linebacker, but he sure has a nose for the ball.
Yeah, they're going to give Dickens 8 yards, and that'll bring up second down and 2.
He's a defensive end, actually.
Inside handoff to McKinney, and he's going to be stuffed in the backfield, and he'll lose a couple of yards.
He'll lose two there, Sarge.
So that'll bring up second down and 4, or third down and 4.
Third down.
And that was number 18, Richard Horton, on the stop for Davenport.
And I believe that's the first yard tackle for loss of yardage that they've had on McKinney all night long.
And Lockhart continues to find himself in third downs.
Third and 4. Dickens gets the snap, drops back, looking for a receiver. Throws it over the middle to Nate Garcia with a beautiful catch. All the way down to the 20-yard line, and another Lockhart Lion first down.
And that's Nate Garcia's first catch of the game, and it couldn't have come at a better time for the Lockhart Lions.
Great catch there, TD. Great catch.
He watched that ball in all the way, and he made sure he secured that one.
Excellent route also.
And so that's the fourth receiver that Dickens has hit tonight. Starting to see him spread the ball around a little bit.
And McKinney's going to be in the backfield, offset to the left side. Dickens will keep the ball coming around the near side. Cuts it upfield. finds room to run before he's finally going to be brought down shy of the 5-yard line. And it'll be first down and goal to go from the 6-yard line.
Tell you what, great block out on the perimeter by Gage Deutsch. That was the one that allowed him to cut up the field behind it. Good job boxing his man out and helping his quarterback get a first down. Got a special place in my heart for receivers that block downfield.
And they call them team players. This one's going to be handed off to Travion Hopkins. He'll get around the edge.
Ooh, almost in.
One shoestring away from getting into the end zone.
And from our angle, we couldn't even see the guy that tackled him. Looked like he just went down. But
he just grabbed an ankle and
I thought
on.
He was there.
So it'll be second down and goal to go from
inches.
The 3.
From the 3?
Yes, from the 3-yard line.
Okay, the stick is in the
weird angle.
Yeah.
Dickens gets the hand snap, hands it off to Travion Hopkins, who goes up the middle into the end zone for a Lockhart Lions touchdown. And if you're at the Lounge Sports Bar, raise one up, and that's a Lockhart Lions touchdown.
And so both teams able to get in the end zone here in the third quarter. Lockhart brings it back to a one-score game once again, pending the extra point.
Ocampo is back to kick the extra point. Snap is back. The hold is down. Laces out, and it is through the uprights and good. And the score is now Wolves 35, Lockhart Lions 28. Back to a one-score game. We're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back with more Lockhart Lions football right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
Old Pal Texas Tavern, located on the square in downtown Lockhart at 100 East Market Street. From a variety of appetizers, fried chicken, burgers, and salads, Old Pal is the right place for your hunger. We are open 7 days a week, Sunday through Thursday 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. and Fridays and Saturdays from 11 a.m. to 12 a.m. Our kitchen will be open late on Lockhart Lions Friday Night Lights home games. Old Pal Texas Tavern's cold drinks, fried chicken, and famous smash burgers are perfect for your after-game score. At Old Pals, we are proud supporters of the Lockhart Lions and the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
And we are back here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast as Travion Hopkins rolls into the end zone from 3 yards out to give the Lions a one-score deficit, trailing the Wolves by a score of 35-28.
I tell you what, Sarge, this Lockhart sideline has really picked up. Look at their heads up, they're pumped, they're ready to go.
Tell you what, Sarge, I'm looking at the near side, number 33, Trey Brown, down here on the bottom. See if he can make something happen.
Let it go, let it go.
Oh.
That was picked up right before the 10-yard mark.
Have I got a nose or what? I felt like Trey's in there. Something's coming this way. Couldn't quite get it.
Great play by that young man. He must be a baseball player. Had good hands.
Yeah, Mikey Scoltetti.
Good job, too, for Lockhart to just kind of be patient there and not touch that ball before it went 10 yards. But he came up and grabbed it at 9 and gave him no chance.
Okay, here we go. Lockhart Lions are going to have to come up with a big stop right here if they're going to want to get the ball back and keep the Wolves out of the end zone and have an opportunity to tie this game up, as we have 1:02 left to go in the Changing Faces Barbershop third quarter. The Wolves have the ball in line territory at the 49-yard line. Hamlin in shotgun formation for the Wolves, man in motion. Hamlin will roll around to his left side. The left-hander will throw it out there. It'll short hop to the receiver. That'll be incomplete.
And that's the first pass that's been really off target for Hamlin all night. But he's had some close misses.
Pressure by the Lockhart defense. Pressure by the Lockhart defense.
And Rivas and Hopkins over there on that far side. Loving the Imperial March.
And here we go, second down and 10. Hamlin in shotgun formation. Wolves are not picking up the tempo as they had in the first quarter, first half.
And maybe taking their time.
Once again, man in motion. Ball's going to be handed off to number 11. Coming around the near side. Big, more room to run. Number 14, Golden. And he's going to be pushed out of bounds by Rivas.
And something tells me, I feel like I've seen that play before, Sarge. As the outside, the off tackle just continues to work for Davenport.
Good job blocking our defensive end there. And also a block on Ramos.
Yeah, first down and 10 at the 23 for the Wolves. Quick throw to the corner of the end zone, and that's going to be incomplete. A little bit too much mustard on that hot dog right there.
That's a good thing, too, because he did have a step on Key on that far side. He's got him turned around. That was just one of those quick shot plays. And so far, the Lockhart defense not had a real good answer here in the second half for this Wolves offense as they've continued to move the ball on short passes and that zone off the right tackle. And it looks like the right tackle, number 55, is a big old boy.
Three receivers up top, one to the bottom. Hamlin drops back. Looking for a throw up the middle. He's going to be pressured to run out of the pocket, and he's going to be brought down by Zakiya Gathing.
You see who's in there, TD, number 98.
Number 98 giving chase, and Gathing's able to clean him up.
He didn't make the tackle, but he put pressure on the quarterback.
That looks like it'll be no gain. That'll bring up third down. Well, 1 yard gain. That'll bring up third down and 9.
Chain crew having a little trouble.
This will probably be the last play of the third quarter. Inside handoff to Golden. He's going to be met at the line of scrimmage. Breaks away from a couple of arm tackles before Travion Hopkins brings him down.
And for the first time since early in the second quarter, the Lions have taken them to fourth down. And looks like they're going to go ahead and call a timeout on the field.
That's going to be the end of the Change of Faces Barbershop third quarter. We're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back with the Shields AC and Heating fourth and final quarter from Davenport High School right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
Shields AC and Heating is a small family-owned business located here in Lockhart, Texas. You can count on us for all your air conditioning and heating repairs. Here at Shields AC and Heating, we service commercial and residential HVAC system as well as refrigeration, ice machines, and walk-in coolers. So, if you're in need of commercial or residential AC repairs, you can count on Shields AC and Heating to be there for you by calling us at 512-227-1219. We take pride in your comfort.
And we are back here for the Shields AC and Heating fourth and final quarter. And gentlemen, I want to share with y'all, I got a nice phone call before the game began while we were setting up. And it was from Shields AC and Heating Repair. They wanted to let us know that we're doing an outstanding job for each and every broadcast. And they are very pleased and becoming a sponsor of the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast and giving us big support. Of course, big supporters of Lockhart Line Football and Lockhart Line Sports as well. So I do want to give them a shout out and thank them for their very kind phone call. And it's always great to hear things like that because that's one of the things that why we do what we do here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. If you can't make it to the game, we'll take the game to you. You know, it sounds a little crazy, but hey, if you close your eyes and listen to the game while we're calling it for you, you're going to be able to envision it. But since we got video, you can go and leave your eyes open. You can watch it as you hear it at the same time.
And to follow up what Tarch said, talking to the Davenport coaches, they showed our film today to the players instead of watching their film because our broadcast was so good from last week.
All right, folks, this is going to be the biggest defensive play of the ball game so far as it is going to be 4th and 3. The ball's going to be out on the 23-yard line. Or rather the 16-yard line.
Yep.
The yard to gain is going to be the 12, so call it 4th and 4.
As you can see here, the Lion fans getting riled up.
Let's go defense.
Yeah, Hamlin, man in motion, coming across the back of the line. Hamlin gets the snap, tosses it over to the running back, and he's going to dive forward.
And he's going to be short of the line to gain, I think. Let's see where they place it.
It's going to be close.
They're going to mark it right around the...
Officials are asking the players to back away.
It looks like
they're going to say first down.
Can we get a measurement? And the Lockhart fans give them what for. And that'll give them a fresh set of downs. Ball just outside the 11-yard line. Caught the 12, so they'll be able to get a first down without scoring.
Takes a handoff to Golden, rolls out to his left side. Had a receiver, but Trey Brown was right there on the spot. That ball's going to be incomplete.
Trey Brown keeping him covered up like a blanket on that play.
Good pass rushing by number nine for the Lockhart Lions.
And as I said earlier, Lockhart has been able to get to the quarterback. Three sacks in the game for Lockhart. Actually, four.
So that'll bring up second down and 10. And in motion, they'll fake the handoff, hand it off to Golden, and he's going to go around the right edge and into the end zone. A play that's been very successful for them tonight.
That zone read is just killing us. It is killing us. We are unable to pick that man up.
Great job of blocking by their Davenport offensive line there, TD.
I believe that's going to be Golden's fourth touchdown of the night. So Gill will be coming in to kick the extra point. Snap is back. The hold is down. The kick is line drive. And that is no good.
No good.
And that's big. That is big. Because while there is a two-touchdown gap in a game like this where it's been tit for tat, that could come to be a big deal by the end of the ball game.
It definitely can, and we'll go ahead and stay right here as we have 11:34 left to go in the Shields AC and Heating fourth and final quarter right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. I want to remind everybody that at the conclusion of this game, we will take a quick timeout, and when we come back, we're going to have your El Rey Crawfish and Oyster Bar post-game show. And during the post-game show, we're going to have your Kreitz Market Offensive Player of the Game and your One Ghost Fitness Defensive Player of the Game. So you're going to want to stay tuned and listen and find out who are players of the game for the Lockhart Lions in today's ball game against the Davenport Wolves.
And I want to highlight something that we did miss last week on our broadcast and all the excitement, and that's that big number 65, Zephaniah Franks, is a freshman, and he was brought up last week to play in that game, and he did play a ton in that game. And he did a great job out there. I went back, watched the broadcast again. The young freshman, 15 years old, did a great job holding it down there, helping support the offensive line. So hats off to that young man. Anytime you see a freshman on varsity, that is definitely something to be recognized.
Yes, and not on the sideline, but actually on the field playing. And that one's going to be fair caught.
Oh.
And it looks like Davenport might have fallen on top of that. And they do.
Wolves recover the muffed kick. Wolves ball, first and 10 from the Lockhart
45 yard line. That was Nathaniel Gonzalez.
Went for the fair catch, but we still lost the ball. We had a trouble catching the making the catch there.
So the Davenport Wolves offense is back in action once again.
So Davenport really taking no chances. You think Coach Davis wants to pour it on or what?
So the Wolves will have two receivers up top, one to the bottom, Golden in the backfield with Hamlin. Hamlin gets the snap, hands it off to Golden up the middle. Got some room to run at the 30, the 20. Makes the move and into the end zone for his fifth touchdown of the night. And the Wolves add another six to the scoreboard.
And I'll tell you what, they missed that extra point, but they came back and got six more.
Great job blocking downfield by the Davenport receivers.
And that'll make it a three-score game with 11 minutes, 23 seconds left to go here in the fourth quarter. Never say never, Lockhart fans. We've seen stranger things happen in the past.
So Gill comes in to kick the extra point. Missed the last one. Snap is a little high, but it's down. The kick is up, and it is good.
Good job by the holder there to get a hold of that one and get it down for his kicker.
Making your score
And right now, we're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back with some more Lockhart Lion football right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
If you're looking to capture that special moment, let Adrian Gutierrez Photography capture that special moment for you. Whether it's a wedding, birthday, family photo, or any special occasion, Adrian Gutierrez Photography is the right one to turn that special moment into a memory that will last a lifetime. Adrian Gutierrez proudly supports Lockhart Lion Athletics and can be seen at many events in Lockhart, as well as at Lockhart Lions sporting events, offering his time to create special moments for the Lockhart community. You can contact Adrian Gutierrez Photography at 512-227-6794, email adriangutierrezphotography@gmail.com, or his website adriangutierrezphotography.com.
All right, and we're back here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
We need a return, baby.
Looks like we're going to have somebody else kicking the ball for the Wolves. That's going to be number 27,
man, he'll be
Miles
a,
Mendez.
He'll be a lefty. We'll see if Mendez kicks it to Reese.
He's going to kick it high to Travion Hopkins, and he's going to have a little hard time hanging on to it, but he'll cover it at the 30-yard line.
All right, and that's where Lockhart will take over. And if they're going to get back in this game, not only are they going to need a score, they're going to need to do it pretty quick.
And I want to remind you, all you Lockhart Lion fans, if you want to be one of two lucky Lion fans to win free tickets to next week's homecoming game versus Cedar Creek at Lions Field, all you got to do is in the comment section, type in the words "Go Lions," and you'll be automatically entered. Also, it is homecoming next week. If you want to have an opportunity, as Kent Riddle Properties has sponsored five mums made by Alexis Jennings. If you want to be one of five lucky Lion fans and win a mum, all you got to do is in the comment section, type in the words "mums for me" as Dickens drops back, throws the ball over the middle, got the receiver wide open, and Gage Deutsch, and just missing him.
I tell you what, Gage Deutsch had a couple steps there, and if they're able to hook up, there's nobody between him and the end zone. He shows the arm off, throwing it from the far hash all the way back to the line judge.
Great job of beating number 17 on the coverage there, well, TD.
Gage Deutsch is a backup quarterback, too.
He toasted him on that play. Too bad he couldn't come up with it. And that'll bring up second and 10 from the 30.
Dickens drops back, looking to throw once again, and that's going to be caught by Gage Deutsch for a first down. Way to come down with it, knowing that he was going to get hit.
And I said it in the pregame, Sarge, we saw him really pop off in the scrimmages, and since then he's caught one or two passes here and there, but really been waiting to see Gage kind of pop off and have a big game, and this could be the start of it for him here.
So here we go, first down and 10 for the Lions at the 41-yard line. Dickens once again dropping back, rolls around to his right because he's got pressure in front of him, throws it out there. Incomplete. The intended receiver was number 18.
Great job by Dickens get the ball out of his hands on that one, as he was under a ton of pressure.
Nate Key was the intended receiver on that play.
Second down for the Lions.
I like what Coach is doing there on that rollout, getting him out on the edge and giving Dickens the chance to see what he's got open downfield and see it all clear in front of him without the line.
That's going to be a handoff to McKinney coming around the near side. And he's going to be brought down for about a 3-yard gain. That'll bring up third down and 7.
Isn't it something else how when you see a defender tackle him out on the edge, you feel like he still got the better of it?
I'm surprised that one guy brought him down.
Yeah. He definitely went low. He did what he had to do. Another third and long here for the Lions.
Yeah, third and 7. Three receivers up top, one to the bottom. Keeper from Dickens, and he'll pick up the first down as he gets into Wolves territory.
An interesting point, Sarge. Lockhart on the season coming into this game, they were over 50% on their third down conversions. They'd gotten up as high as 60% before the last game.
And that'll be a big first down. Ball's going to be placed at the 39 in Wolf territory. Lions are moving the ball down the field. Dickens dropping back, looking for a receiver, throws it up the middle to Deontay Jackson, and that one's going to be incomplete. A little bit of contact by the defender, not going to be called.
So Lockhart definitely taking some shots. I mean, really trying to do what they can to try to get back into this thing.
Yes, sir, TD. They're going to have to if they want to get back in the ballgame.
So here we go. Second down and 10. Two receivers up top, one to the bottom. They'll fake the handoff to McKinney up the middle, and they'll get it out there to Nate Garcia.
And Garcia makes his second grab of the game.
And he'll get it down to the 30-yard line. That'll bring up third down and two.
I'm glad to see Garcia stepping up and playing a good ball game tonight.
That'll be third down and one.
Well, I think that's really important for our success for the rest of this game is moving the ball around the field on both sides, hitting multiple receivers.
Quarterback sneak.
And he'll pick up the first down as Dickens moves the pile.
Quarterback sneak, that went for 4 or 5 yards. Just do it again. Dickens almost squirted out the other side.
And the Lions will hurry up and line it up. First down and 10. Ball is at the 25-yard line. Fake the handoff to McKinney. Had a host of Wolves following him. Pass is going to be thrown out there to Nate Garcia, and he'll make a beautiful catch along the sideline. Stays in bounds.
Awesome, awesome catch by Garcia.
Down to the 16-yard line. That'll be first down and 10 for the Lions.
And beautiful, beautiful fake on that play. It had several of the players from Davenport bite and end up on the ground and inside of Dickens' feet. We'll see if they take a shot into the end zone here.
This will be an opportune time to do that. They'll fake the handoff to McKinney, and that'll bite. The defense will bite on that one as he comes right back to McKinney.
Oh.
And that's going to be pass interference in the end zone.
And I don't know how, but somehow a big defensive lineman found himself out there guarding McKinney. That's number 75. Or no, that's okay. That's 25 who we've seen all night. But he really had no choice there as he didn't see the ball coming, and McKinney knew it, so he tries to play back through him and draws the flag. That's almost the equivalent of drawing that foul in basketball right
yes.
there. You know, you see that you've got the chance, and you just got to run through
it. Yeah, and not only that, if it was a lineman out there, I'm pretty sure the coach would be like, pass interference.
Yeah.
They'll be yelling for him to throw a pass interference out there. You know, they say 15 is better than 6.
And that's going to move the ball down half the distance to the goal.
I guess they were trying to figure out if it was going to be holding or pass interference. And that'll put the ball at the 2-yard line, first down and goal from there. Surprised we're not seeing Dickens underneath the center for another quarterback sneak. And that'll be a handoff to McKinney going around the left side. Nice block on the outside by Nate Garcia. And McKinney will get into the end zone and put 6 on the board.
And that was Deutsch out on that far side with that block.
And for all you that are at the Lounge Sports Bar, raise one up to the sky, as that is another Lockhart Lion touchdown.
And so Lockhart takes less than 2 minutes to score, or just over 2 minutes to score on that drive, taking 2 minutes off the clock.
Snap is back, the hold is down, the kick is up, and it is good.
And there's going to be 9 minutes and 8 seconds left to go in this ball game. That's going to take the score to 35-48. It's going to be a two-possession game, but 1 point short of 14.
And a 13-point difference. And we'll keep it right here as we got 9:08 left to go here in the Shields AC and Heating fourth and final quarter.
Now, Sarge, you asked about the onside kick a little earlier. And I'm starting to feel it a little bit more this time. But we did see him make an attempt at it and just unable to come up with it.
I'll tell you what, if we see Jackson and Reese on the same side of the field, you could bet my bottom dollar that that's the side that they're going to. But I see Jackson here on the sideline, so we won't see both of them. So I get to keep my bottom dollar in my pocket.
I'm sure Coach Brandon Davis is ready for it.
Oh, yeah, you know he told them before they came out, y'all be ready. And they look like they do have the hands team. Yep, they got their hands team out. They're only going to drop one guy back. Hey, we know Ocampo has a really good little pooch kick. I'd be interested to see here if he doesn't try to pooch kick it around the 30-yard line and see if Reese can't get down there and try to get a hand on it.
Maybe give it a little squib kick. Here we go, Ocampo steps up to it, and he'll kick it deep. That's going to go in and out of the end zone.
Very deep.
Campo booted that one.
Got to stop him here, TD.
Need two big stops.
And if there's been a shining point for the Lockhart team so far this season, it has been defense. So an opportunity here for the stingy Lockhart defense to step up and get a stop. Lockhart only allowing 16 points per game up until tonight. Tonight, Lockhart has given up 48. Of course, they're most on the year so far, but you got to think this defense is going to want to stiffen up and get a stop here and put the ball back in the hands of Dickens.
A turnover would be great.
And there have been no turnovers. I guess there was a couple squib muffed kicks for fumbles.
So here we go. Hamlin in the backfield, shotgun formation. Golden will get the handoff going around the right side and once again finding a lot of room out there on the right side. And he's going to be brought down from behind by Josh Ramos, having another fantastic game defensively for the Lions.
Zone read off tackle, goes for 23 yards.
Excellent job of blocking it for them.
Finding a lot of success over that right side. That'll be a pass out here to number four.
Oh, got to
break through
tackle.
An arm tackle. And then finally he's going to be knocked down in line territory at the 29-yard line by Zakiya Gathings. Now they're going to mark him down at the 30. And here comes that quick pace offense once again by the Wolves. First down, Wolves. And that'll be a handoff where they're going to fake it and Hamlin. Yeah, he's going to go down instead of getting hit.
Hamlin on the carry.
And shout out to Curtis Hawkins, who's watching us from his party bus. If you ever find yourself in need to move a big group of people, give him a call and he will hook you up. He's got several options for you.
Second and 12 down.
Come on, Curtis. Bring us to a ball game in style, man.
That's right.
Make us feel like a superstar. 8:02 left to go here in the Shields AC and Heating fourth and final quarter from Davenport Wolves Stadium. Wolves leading Lockhart Lions 48-35. Wolves on the move though. First down, second down and 12. Oh, and that's going to be a stop in the backfield.
And that's going to be Staten there for the stop. Comes into the game and gets a stop, gets his name called. Great job by the young man playing right defensive tackle.
He's playing in the spot of Derek Rivas.
And that's Tyler Staten.
And that was a big stop on Golden too right there, as he has found a lot of success as he was trying to go over the right side.
And third and long down for the Davenport.
And we haven't seen a whole lot of these in the game today.
And if there's a stop Lockhart needs, this is it right here. Third down and 12. Man in motion coming across the line of scrimmage. They'll hand the ball off to Golden around the right side. And he'll get it down towards the 22-yard line. It'll still be shy of the first down of about 3 yards.
Fourth down.
You know where it's going. They're going zone read to the right side. You got to bring Ramos off that edge and see if you can stop it.
I agree, TD. I think he's too far back.
Get up there, Ramos. It's coming to you. Oh, going to be a pass.
Quick pass out to the far right side. And Quavon Reese will be right there to knock the receiver out of bounds. But not before he's able to pick up a first down.
And not only is Davenport moving the ball, but they are chewing valuable time off this clock as we're now down to 6 minutes and 34 seconds left to go in this contest.
And he'll hand the ball off to Golden as he'll make his way around the left side. And he'll pick up about 5 yards.
That'll be Gathens and Hopkins there combining for that tackle. With Gathens, he's definitely got a little hitch in his giddy up as he's limping around out there, but hanging tough and playing strong.
Second down.
And Golden gets the handoff going around the right side. Once again, a big hole created out there.
And touchdown saving tackle there by Jackson. That's going to bring up third down. That'll be a first down.
First and goal.
This will be first and goal from the 5-yard line.
First and goal.
First and goal to go from the 5. Golden will get the handoff, trying to go around the right side, and coming in from the backside to make the tackle is going to be Tyler Stanton. And that clock continues to go down.
As the Lockhart band gives you a little smoke on the water. You got to think if the Lions don't stop them here, that'll just about put a cap on it.
And the handoff is going to go to Golden. He'll go up the middle and into the end zone for another Davenport Wolf touchdown. And that's going to be his 6th touchdown of the game, gentlemen.
That young man's making a case to get his name heard on a lot of platforms tonight and over the weekend.
I'm sure the San Antonio stations are really going to pick up on that.
And so that brings the score to 54, be 55 pending the extra point. So the Lockhart defense that had only given up 16 points a game up to this point in the year has given up more than 3 times their average to the Davenport Wolves. Another high snap, but he gets it down. The kick is up, and it is good. So that will make the score 55-35. Davenport Wolves with a 20-point lead over your Lockhart Lions. 5 minutes and 14 seconds left to go here in the fourth quarter.
Now let's go through a quick rundown of district scores at Pflugerville. It is Pflugerville Panthers 34, Bastrop Bears 21 in the third quarter. At Leander Rouse, it is Liberty Hill Panthers 28, the Rouse Raiders 21 in the third quarter.
That's a close contest.
At Elgin, it is at halftime, Elgin Wildcats 20, Cedar Creek Eagles 7.
Shout out to the Elgin Wildcats. They've also been in the top 10 in the state on stingy defenses.
At Hallettville, the Brahmas 28 or 25, San Antonio Piper Warriors 0.
Wow.
San Antonio Veterans Memorial 14, Canyon Lake Hawks 6. That's at halftime. And at Marble Falls, Kerrville Tyvee 20, Marble Falls 14. And other Caldwell County school, Luling Eagles at Boylan to take on the Bulldogs. It is halftime. That score is 20-6. And if you're a Buda Hayes fan, it is, they have it in the second quarter, and the score is 28-7 over the MacArthur Brahmas of San Antonio.
And Luling on a roll this year.
And go back to Liberty Hill and Rouse. They're actually neighbors, so it's a really pretty big rivalry there.
High pooch kick going to be caught by Travion Hawkins. He'll hang on to this one as he brings it upfield. Gets a nice little return out of it. All the way down to the 48-yard line where the Lions are going to take over. First down and 10. 24 to throw loss. Tripped up the return. They're trailing by 20.
Lions ball first and 10 on their own 48-yard line.
And so the Lions have not had problems moving the ball down the field, getting in the end zone. But they have had problems keeping the Wolves out. On that last drive, Lockhart very methodical, moving down the field on a combination of Dickens runs, McKinney runs, and then passes from Dickens to both Deutsch and
Nate Garcia.
And Garcia. Yeah. See if they can do it again.
Dickens gets snapped, drops back, looking over the middle.
Good
catch.
That's
a receiver out there, Nate Garcia.
That one just short of the sticks. It'll bring up, we'll see where they're going to mark
that's
it.
They're going to get one right at the 42-yard line.
That's
going to
be a first down.
Yeah, first down, this line to line.
Right Garcia's at 10 breakout party. First down
line. Well, definitely do.
Dickens drops back. Throwing out there to the flats, and that one's going to be caught by Nate Garcia once again.
Wow. Where's Garcia been all this year?
Yeah, Garcia, I think he only had 2, maybe 3 catches on the year before tonight.
Yeah, receiver by committee, as Coach Mavis talked about it during our kickoff show, and Nate Garcia is the man right now. Dickens dropping back once again, throwing deep down the sideline. Intended target was Deontay Jackson, but great job by Brown, who was step-for-step with Jackson, which is something very difficult to do with a speedster like Deontay.
Now Brown definitely has some speed of his own. On your feet. That's going to be 3rd down and 5. Crucial 3rd down here for the Lions. Ball's going to be on the 37-yard line.
So it's going to be 3rd down and 5. Oh, and the snap's going to get away from Dickens. He's going to pick it up, run around the left side. makes something out of nothing, and he'll pick up a first down.
Absolutely unreal. Dickens was able to pick that ball up while he had a whole host of Wolves around him. Somehow still gets away from him. Moves the chains for the team. That man is a football player.
There's no quitting his game, TD.
So first down and 10. The ball is at the 29-yard line in Wolf territory. Dickens gets the snap, draws back. Got the receiver wide open, and Blake Herzog, he'll break away from one tackler. Gets around the edge, and he'll make the first down before he's going to be brought down at the 13-yard line, where it's going to be another first down and 10 for the Lions.
Great job by Herzog. Juking one, making a second one miss, and then yards after contact to move the chains for his team a little bit closer to the end zone. So Lockhart still showing that fighting spirit, that's for sure.
So first down and 10. Lions have an opportunity to get another first down. Dickens dropping back, throws it over the middle.
Ooh,
and just a little short. A
little bit short.
Felt like also might have been a little early, but no call.
Intended receiver was Gage Deutsch on that play.
Soberall in the coverage. He was all over Deutsch.
Three receivers up top, one to the bottom. Dickens will keep it coming around the right side. Got some blockers in front of him. Will get into the end zone.
What a block.
For another Lockhart Lion touchdown.
Huge block to seal the edge by McKinney. That's what sprung him.
And once again, if you're at the Lounge Sports Bar, raise one up to the sky, because that is another Lockhart Lion touchdown. Oh, Koppel will come in to kick the extra point. Snap is back, the hold is down, the kick is up, and it is good. And that'll make the score. Davenport 55, Lockhart Lions 42 with 3:43 left to go into the Shields AC and Heating fourth and final quarter. We're going to take a quick timeout, and we'll be right back with more Lockhart Lion football right here on the Lions Pride Sports broadcast.
Working hand in hand with the community to keep our Lions safe. This school year, Lockhart ISD is launching Lion Guard, a community watch program in which individuals can apply to volunteer and be a positive presence on the campuses for students while also monitoring and checking for any potential safety concerns. All Lion Guard volunteers must undergo a criminal background check and will participate in civilian response to active shooter events training and stop the bleed training. Anyone who is interested is welcome to apply. Go to the Lockhart ISD website and from the menu tab click on Parents and scroll down to hit the Volunteer in LISD. Join the Pride of Lockhart. Tab and sign up.
Ready for it. What a shootout.
It is. Lockhart's down by 13. They need to get this one. And it looks like with 3:43 left to go in the Shields AC and Heating fourth and final quarter, it seems like this will be an onside try as we see Quavon Reese, Travion Hopkins, Zakai Ganthes, Trey Brown, Nathaniel Gonzalez, and Sean McKinney on the near side.
You've got Ganthes on the end. He'll be looking to blow it up.
Oh, it's a free ball.
Lockhart's got
and
it.
Lockhart will recover the ball. That's going to be Sean McKinney coming up with it.
Great job of execution of the onside kick by Lockhart. Great kick by Ocampo. Took a bounce Lockhart's way. Lockhart will get the ball at the 46-yard line. They'll have 3 minutes and 42 seconds left. We'll try to see if they can pull it to within one score. And then maybe they'll be able to make a miracle happen after that.
TD, the ball hit number 5 for Davenport and it just bounced off.
Hit him hard. Good, yeah, hard onside kick.
Yeah, he's hurting. He's still in there playing defense, though.
You see him holding his
tough guy.
So the Lions are going to come back out on offense. Three receivers up top, one to the bottom. Dickens will get the snap, dropping back. That's going to be a screen pass to McKinney, and he's going to get it to the 50-yard line. He stretched out for it. Picks up an extra yard.
We blocked the first play, but we didn't block the second play.
Yeah, I think they got a little excited and got a little far out in front of him on that one. But he still picks up a positive gain.
Second down and 7.
Clock running.
Dickens dropping back. Wanting to throw deep. Going to have to hang on to it. And just throws it away. And
great job to get rid of the ball.
Yes, sir. Great job.
That was very close to end the grasp right there as well. So that's going to bring out third down and long for the Lions. Third down and 7 at that.
Better get the first down.
And more importantly, Dickens stopped the clock with that incomplete pass.
Lockhart with no problem converting on third downs. Last big one was converted to Garcia.
Definitely four down territory for the Lions.
Oh, no.
And that one's going to be blown up before it even starts, as Dickens is going to be sacked for a loss.
Nobody picked up the blitzing linebacker, TD.
And that's number 52 coming in strong.
And the Lions are going to call a timeout. And we'll take a quick timeout,
clock
too.
Clock is still running again.
We'll take a quick timeout, too, and we'll be right back with some more Lockhart Lion football right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast.
If you're looking
fourth down, they're
going to
bring
them. Look no further than Raina Drywall and Paint. Owner and operator Robert Raina is MBE, BBE, and HUB certified. Whether it's commercial or residential, metal framing, suspended ceilings, doors and hardware, Raina Drywall and Paint is the one to call. You can call Robert Raina at 512-925-0634 or you can send an email to rainaconstruction@sbcglobal.com.
And we are back, and after the sack on Dickens, it is fourth down and 13.
And we'll have an official timeout here for a second as they get that clock reset, as once again it continued to run after the timeout was called. We'll see just how much they put back on it. And it's going to be 2 minutes and 56 seconds. They put 12 seconds back on the clock.
TD, they've been bringing those backers the last two plays. I'm sure they're going to bring them again.
So you got Reese in the slot.
Make some noise.
Trying to hit him on a slant.
Snap is back. Dickens stepping in. And he'll throw that one away. That'll be incomplete.
Too much pressure coming at the quarterback.
Yep. And, you know, they only brought three that time, and they were still able to get pressure on it. Well, so that'll turn the ball over, and they'll get the ball on the 45-yard line. There'll be 2 minutes and 49 seconds left.
Lockhart Lions has two timeouts left to go. Wolves will have all three. But with every second that ticks off the clock, that takes away any time that Lockhart needs for any possibility of a comeback, as Hamlin comes back out onto the field with Golden offset to the right side of him. That's going to be a jet sweep to number 4 going around the right side, and he's going to find some room out there before it's finally going to be brought down by Deontay Jackson.
And that's the first thing, the first time they've given it on the jet sweep.
Really hurting us on that right side, TD.
And I want to take a minute to give a shout-out to a couple folks. I want to shout-out my good old boys crew who's watching back home in Lockhart, getting ready for our big annual trip next week, which will keep me out of the broadcast booth for homecoming. But, you know, I'll be calling in for the pregame show and probably check in at halftime as well.
Oh, yes.
And I'm sure you guys will be in good hands with Sergeant the Coach next week.
We have a lot of special guests coming up.
I've got a big appointment with a shark. So,
Golden gets the handoff, goes up the middle, and he's going to be brought down from behind after being slowed down by Trey Brown. That's going to be Zakiah Gathings with the stop.
Tell you what, it's a real thing of beauty, because Golden is not exploding lightning quick through there. What he's doing is being very patient, getting nice and low, tucking behind the tackle until he sees his opportunity to slip out, and he just – very workmanlike moves that ball down the field.
Good job following his blockers.
Yes, it's not super flashy, but boy, is it effective. And the clock running. We're now under 2 minutes to go in this ball game. So
we got about 10 seconds on the play clock. And Golden does have six rushing touchdowns tonight. And they'll fake the handoff to him. They'll throw it out to the receiver out here at the flat, and he'll get around the defender and into the end zone for another Davenport touchdown.
And so it looks like, barring an absolute miracle, Davenport is going to move on to 4-0. Lockhart will drop to 3-1, a very respectable record going into district next week with Cedar Creek coming into town. Cedar Creek has struggled on the year. And so I do give Lockhart a pretty good chance to win their district opener.
And that's going to be homecoming night for the Lions.
And it'll be district openers for many teams all around the state next weekend.
It's going to be 70s week, Sarge, for homecoming.
Kick is good. That's going to take it back to a 20-point ball game. Lockhart giving up 62 in this one.
And we got some updates right now. Pflugerville Panthers 42, Bastrop Bears 28. Bastrop Bears looks like they'll be going to 0-4. Liberty Hill Panthers 49, Leander Rouse 21. San Antonio MacArthur Brahmas 14, Buda Hayes 64. Bastrop Cedar Creek Eagles 7, Elgin Wildcats 44. That's in the fourth quarter. San Antonio Piper Warriors 0, Hallettsville Brahmas 25. That's in the fourth quarter. Also in the fourth quarter, San Antonio Veterans Memorial 28, Canyon Lake Hawks 28.
Wow.
And at Marble Falls, it is Kerrville Tyvee Antlers 28, Marble Falls Mustangs 21. That's fourth quarter with about a minute and a half left to go.
Wow.
And the Boiling Bulldogs all over the Luling Eagles. Well, they just changed the score. It was 32-6.
I thought the Eagles were up when you called it earlier. You didn't give us which side was winning.
Yeah. It looks like someone's playing with a score over there, but it's 32-6.
So I tell you what, Sarge, you mentioned something that I kind of want to call attention to, and that's the fact that Bastrop's 0-4. And I'm going to tell you, Lockhart Lion fans, you can forget about the record when it comes to that game. And something else really interesting that's happened is Bastrop was 0-3 at the beginning of this week, now 0-4. Their quarterback, Mauser, is the number one passing quarterback in the state, having gone he was just under 1,000.
And here we go, Quavon Reese with a big return. And that ball is going to be fumbled, but out of bounds. But I tell you what a return by Quavon Reese.
Huge return by Quavon, and he would catch me talking about another team and give me a big return that I'm always looking for. But, yeah, I just wanted to kind of point that out, that Bastrop may be 0-4, but it's not that they're not performing. They're scoring points, and their quarterback has been airing it out, just unable to get the W's.
That quarterback is a three-year starter, TD.
That's Mauser.
He's committed to UTEP. And he doesn't look like a quarterback. He looks like a tight end. Actually, he looks like a tackle. Big guy. Real big guy.
I'll tell you what, I guarantee he's well over 1,000 yards on the season now, as he was at 939 leading the state coming into tonight. Just incredible. You can be leading the state in passing and not have won a game.
Yeah, Dickens drops back, and that one's almost going to be intercepted, as that pass was intended for
Deutsch.
Yeah, Gage Deutsch. And I tell you what, gentlemen, we may be down by 20 points with 1:15 left to go, but I don't see that many fans leaving the stands right now. They're sticking around to the very end.
They sure are not. We are playing for pride, and we're going to do everything we can do to maintain as much of that pride as possible.
That's a big difference from the last 2 years, is usually the stands would be emptying out by now. Second down and 10, inside handoff to Sean McKinney. Got a big hole up front. Hurdles a defender all the way down to the 11-yard line.
Number 11 said, where'd he go?
Yeah, I tell you what. Yeah, we may be down by 20, but let me make a highlight reel run.
That's why Sean McKinney was really one of the top running backs in the Austin area.
Another inside handoff to McKinney. This time he's going to be stuffed in the backfield for a 1 yard loss.
They were ready for him that time. That was number 18 on the tackle.
And we're going to be underneath 1 minute. Left to go here in the ball game.
And that's a 2 yard loss on that play. Second down and, or 1 yard loss, second and 11.
Dickens dropping back, got the defender right in front of him. And he's just going to run it out of bounds. He'll take a loss of yardage on that one.
Well, you got to get rid of the ball, because that's going to be a big loss. Loss of 6 yards on that one. Going to bring up Third down and 17 for the Lions.
I tell you what, TD Coach, a big turnaround from what the offensive line did last week. They're facing a three-man front and unable to hold off as Dickens has had pressure right in front of them all throughout the second half.
Well, and they've got their own Revis there in the middle who has been taking on a double team most all night. And number 25 has also played very well for their defensive line.
Dickens will get the snap, drops back once again, got pressure right in front of him. We'll dump it off to Sean McKinney around the left side. Got the block, cuts it up the middle and into the end zone for another Lockhart Lion touchdown.
What? Why aren't they signaling touchdown? Hold it, Lockhart.
Surprise.
So that's going to take the touchdown off the board.
Come on, Coach Davis. Where's your love for your old team? Just let us keep it.
Hold it on the Lockhart Lions with 31 seconds left to go in the ball game.
And that'll be a spot foul. Now Holden was downfield. It's not even going to move the stick. The penalty is going to be enforced, and it's going to be at the same spot. So it's going to be fourth down and 17. Ball on the 20-yard line. Lockhart faithful staying strong.
So it'll be third down and long. So we're going to have three receivers to the near side, one up top. Dropping back. Throwing it into the end zone, and that one's going to be incomplete. Attended receiver was Blake Herzog.
Yeah, it was nowhere near Herzog. It was thrown out of bounds. No chance to get to it.
And that's going to bring up fourth down and long, fourth and 15.
And Lockhart can get a first down without getting in the end zone. They'd have to make it down to right around the two, three-yard line. And so they'll have one more chance to sling it for the end zone.
Dickens rolled around to his right side. Keeps
there
it.
There he goes.
He'll cut it up. Ooh. And he's going to be shy of the first down.
And with 13 seconds left in the game, we'll see the Davenport Wolves come out to put the knee down. And that'll pretty much wrap this one up. Score is 62-42, Davenport.
Once again, I want to remind you at the conclusion of the game, we're going to take a quick timeout. And when we come back, we're going to have your L. Ray Crawfish and Oyster Bar post-game show. And we'll have your Kreitz Market Offensive Player of the Game and your One Goes Fitness Defensive Player of the Game. So you're going to want to stick around to watch that. And we'll make it quick as I got to hustle down there to unplug it before they lock us in.
So we'll have all the time in the world because there is going to be a band performance by the Davenport Band. They will be performing their UIL piece for their UIL band competition after the game here. So you'll have a little bit of something to look at in the background as well as maybe some music behind us. But that's going to do it for this one. Lockhart falls to 3-1 on the season to the Davenport Wolves, who move to 4-0 by a score of 62-42 here just outside of San Antonio, Texas at Davenport High School Stadium.
Now we're going to take a quick timeout. We'll be right back with the L. Ray Crawfish and Oyster Bar postgame show right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. I just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my head. Go on, tell a friend. Best revenge. Heard it was sleeping again, say it no more. This is a rude awakening, kicking the door. Back and I'm better than ever before. Don't get it mistaken, I'm ready for war. I just came back for the win. Lot of new money in my hand. Go on, tell a friend. I just came back for the win.
Here at El Rey Crawfish and Oyster Bar, we are a family-owned restaurant. We specialize in the world-renowned New Orleans-style seafood. We serve a variety of fresh and flavorful seafood dishes such as fish, shrimp, crab, crawfish, octopus, and oysters. We also have indoor and outdoor dining. So come on out and enjoy your favorite drink and seafood dish at El Rey Crawfish and Oyster Bar, located at 1721 South Commerce Street in Lockhart, Texas.
And we are back here at Davenport Stadium as the Lockhart Lions fall to 3-1 on the season and their last non-district game before we head off to district, as it's going to be homecoming night for the Lockhart Lions, and they'll be welcoming the Cedar Creek Eagles of Bastrop, Texas. As the Eagles are 0-4, the Lions will be going into that contest 3-1. But as we mentioned before the game, you could throw away the non-district record as we go back to 0-0 as we go into district play. But right now, I want to welcome everybody to the El Rey Crawfish and Oyster Bar postgame show right here on the Lions Pride Sports broadcast, as the Lions fall to defeat 62-42 against the Davenport Wolves, who go to 4-0 on the season. I want to thank everybody for tuning in and watching tonight's broadcast with myself, Miller Sarge Wattis, TD Tom Dunn on color commentary, and our football analyst, Coach Amado Galvez, as we have the band playing, the alma mater. We'll let that play on. And once again, welcome everybody to the El Rey Crawfish and Oyster Bar postgame show right here on the Lions Pride Sports broadcast. And once again, Lockhart Lions fall to defeat 62-42. Want to give a big shout out to the Lounge Sports Bar, the official watch party of Lockhart Lions football right here on the Lions Pride Sports broadcast. Want to thank you all for tuning in and for raising one up with every Lockhart Lions score tonight. Unfortunately, Lockhart Lions fall short, and we'll go to 3-1. Fellas, Coach, your thoughts of the game today?
I think we played a tough opponent. Of course, the penalties didn't help us. We have to regroup and start district next week.
TD?
That's right. Hold your head up high. You gotta have a short memory at this point, because the real season starts next week. Your path to the playoffs starts next week, so you got to put this one behind you, get ready to go, and get ready to go give it heck against Cedar Creek at Lockhart Homecoming next week.
Oh, yes, and welcome to the once again to the El Rey Crawfish and Oyster Bar postgame show, where we're going to have your Player of the Game honors. And we're going to start off on the offensive side, and I'll go and hand that one out as the Christ Market Offensive Player of the Game is going to go to Sean McKinney, number 5 of the Lockhart Lions. He did a fantastic job out there and did a great job, got into the end zone several times, and would have gotten a reception, a touchdown for a reception, had not been called for a holding penalty. But congratulations to Sean McKinney. You are the Christ Market Offensive Player of the Game.
And
I'll kick it over to DD for the One Ghost Fitness Player of the Game.
On the defensive side of the ball, our One Ghost Fitness Player of the Game is going to go to Trey Brown, number 33. He was laying the wood the whole game. He blew up a bunch of screens and just stayed right on his man the whole game and just really played an overall good game. Had a lot of guys had good games tonight, but Trey Brown is your One Ghost Fitness Defensive Player of the Game tonight.
So congratulations to Trey Brown and Sean McKinney. You are the players of the game tonight against the Davenport Wolves. And gentlemen, well, the non-district games are over with.
Good to see.
As we're all here, thank you very much. As Stephen Brown comes by, gives us a handshake.
And that's the dad of our Defensive Player of the Game tonight.
So we had Lockhart Lions will be heading back to the drawing board to fix what was, you know, where Davenport was able to get around that left side of the defensive line. And, you know, I'm pretty sure Coach Mavis and is going to have this group ready to go as they take on Cedar Creek.
Yes, sir, because those plays that Davenport scored on, that's exactly Cedar Creek's going to attack us.
Yes, and it's despite the 0-4 record for Cedar Creek, everybody 0-0 when we head off into district play, and that's exactly where we're going to. But still nice to know Lockhart Lions were able to go 3-1 in non-district play. Of course, 4-0 sounds better, but 3-1 is a far cry from where they were the last 2 years, where Lockhart Lions only won 2 games in a 2-year span. So, you know, congratulations to Coach Mavis and where he's got this team at today, and we look forward to district play starting next week. And one more opportunity for you Lockhart Lion fans that have stuck around to watch the LRA postgame show right here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. If you want to be one of two Lockhart Lion fans to win free tickets to next week's homecoming game, courtesy of Kent Riddle Properties and the Lion Pride Sports Broadcast, type in the comment section, Go Lions. And if you want to be one of five Lucky Lion fans to win a mum made by Alexis Jennings, courtesy of Kent Riddle Properties, all you got to do is in the comment section, type in the words, Mums for Me. And you'll be automatically entered. The mums will be drawn. The names will be drawn tomorrow night. The free tickets will be drawn on Monday night. So once again, gentlemen, non-district play is over with. I look forward to being in the booth with y'all again next week at Lionsfield. Of course, TD, you have other plans.
I'll be watching with my toes in the sand. Oh,
exactly. And we'll be in the booth with myself and the coach, and we're going to have several guests coming in.
Several old Lockhart Lions.
Yeah, so we won't tell you who's going to be in there, but you're going to have to tune in so you can see who it is and who we're going to have in the booth with us. But that's going to do it for tonight here at Davenport, here on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. Davenport defeats the Lions and remains unbeaten on the season, 62-42. And like I always say, you can take the lion out of Lockhart, but you can never take the heart out of Lockhart. Go Lions.
Thank you for watching today's broadcast of Lockhart Lion Sports, brought to you by Kent Riddle Properties on the Lions Pride Sports Broadcast. And remember, like the Sarge always says, you can take the lion out of Lockhart, but you can never take the heart out of Lockhart.